offense here at Illinois with a redshirt freshman quarterback who has been part of the talk of the story here in Champaign, Nathan Shieldhouse. There's Jerry Kill. He had a rather unusual week. After the first game of the season on a Thursday night against Iowa State, he underwent some surgery not related to the cancer surgery he had earlier in his career, came back really quickly and coached the team for the next week against North Dakota State, then went to the hospital after last week's game and spent most of this week in the hospital. He was released on Thursday night, taking care of some issues related to that surgery, but he's back on the sidelines here this afternoon, and no one is surprised that he made it back for the game. Captain's meeting at the 50-yard line. Dennis Lipsky is the official who is administering the coin toss. We'll hear from him this afternoon.
In Illinois, that's a red for head, and that's a tail. I'm going to throw it up in the air. Let it drop. What's your call? Tails is called. It's a head. Illinois has won the toss. And has elected to defer to the second half. You want the ball? Okay.
So Northern Illinois will start with the football. Illinois begins on defense. And let's go back to Coach Ron Zook, who was talking about his new offensive coordinator earlier today.
But you know what? It's been a lot of fun. And you know what? I really believe that I've probably made some suggestions to him that he's kind of thought about as well, because I talked to him about what defensive guys are looking at. But Paul's done a great job. The staff has done a great job. Everybody's on the same page. And I really believe our offense is just ready to, we're very, very close to blowing off.
And again, there's the offensive staff led by Coach Petrino in his first season here at Illinois. The Fighting Illini of Illinois, a record of 1-1, getting set for Big Ten play that begins next week with Ohio State coming to town. Coach Ron Zook led this university to the Rose Bowl a few seasons ago. It was his sixth season. He was the 2007 Liberty Mutual Coach of the Year. Illinois will kick to Northern Illinois to start the proceedings. Today's opening kickoff is brought to you by Hass Avocados. Derek Dimke, who hit a 52-yard field goal in the opener against Illinois, set to kick it away here this afternoon. Great to have you with us. And we're underway. Tommy Davis about 4 yards deep on the retreat, downs it, and Northern Illinois will take over first and 10 from its 20-yard line. Redshirt junior quarterback Chandler Harnish had some issues with knee problems during the offseason, did not start the opener, but came on last week and rushed for a career best, 178 yards and a touchdown in the victory over North Dakota last week. He gets the start at quarterback. First and 10 for the white clad Huskies. Harnish in the pistol formation. Chad Spann right behind him. They get motion off the wing for the fullback. Here comes Chad Spann bouncing to the outside, able to slip a tackle attempt. And Martez Wilson brings him down to the 27-yard line. The Rotel Velveeta starting offense, because you can't start your game day without their famous queso dip. Take a look at it for the NIU Huskies. Trevor Olson is the star. He's an all-conference candidate starting for the third time in his career. And then the skill position people, Chad Spann, who just carried the football. He's the bell cow in the offensive backfield. Second down. Spann again. This time, Nate Bussey forced him back inside into the pursuit. And it's a third down upcoming off a loss of one. And now for the Auto Owners Insurance starting defense for Illinois. Clay Nurse very active at the bandit position on the defensive line. In the linebacking corps, Ian Thomas, who is in on that last tackle, has had the best season thus far. Very good outside linebacker. Nate Bussey as well. And then in the secondary, they've been scrambled due to injuries. Justin Green has great speed on the corner. Third down for Northern Illinois. Third at about five. once again on the ground. Spann nowhere to go. Nate Bussey all over it. Pickup of one. Fourth down, Huskies.
Stop by number 26, Justin Green. Gain of one on the play.
So fourth down for Northern Illinois.
At their own 26-yard
They'll bring in Josh Wilbert to do the punting, averaging 36 yards a punt. Back deep, Jack Ramsey. First punt of the day, and here it is. Ramsey, fair catch signal early, and makes the catch near the Illini 32-yard line, where Illinois will put it in play. Well, we talked of the signal caller for this Fighting Illini team in his first season on the field, a redshirt freshman out of Rockhurst High School in Kansas City, Missouri, number two, Nathan Schielhaus. His dad played for the University of Iowa. Schielhaus really came on last week as a passer, 14 of 18 passing in that victory over Southern Illinois. LeShore and Ford in the backfield, and they call this the shot. It's really a version of the pistol offense, and the option to LeShore. And he is off to a tremendous start again this season, among the nation's leaders in rushing per game. Moose?
Yeah, this is called the shot right here, and what they're going to do is they're going to fake to Ford and then get the ball out to LeShore on the edge. He has an opportunity to expand that play up the field. First down, great start for their offense.
First down on an 18-yard pickup out to the midfield marker. Schielhaus with a fullback to his left. LeShore once again. Good, tough run by the Champaign native down to the 44-yard line of Northern Illinois. Well, enough for the Fighting Illini. There are 300 pounds across the front of that offensive line. Jeff Allen, the best of the bunch. And in the offensive skill position areas, Darius Malines is a freshman worth watching on the perimeter. Second down and four off the gain of six. Schielhaus alone in the shotgun. Plenty of time. A.J. Jenkins has been his favorite receiver for a first down. At the 37-yard line of Northern Illinois, the safety Tommy Davis on the stop.
Good for Illinois. First down.
Illinois changing the tempo a bit here. Moose going no huddle. First and 10. This time LeShore in the backfield with Schielhaus, and they're getting the play right now signaled in from the sidelines. Paul Petrino is up here in the box, but it's the play signaled in from the sidelines. And Schielhaus still has it to the 20. Down near the 10-yard line. Tommy Davis on the tackle. Great play fake by Schielhaus, and it popped wide open.
That time, Illinois comes out in a run look. They fake the ball up the middle, and then Schielhaus just takes off, and the eyes are all on that great rusher, LeShore. Schielhaus is able to get up the field for a big play.
28 yards on the scamper. First down, they mark it inside the 10. It's first and goal. A keeper once again. Schielhaus vaults into the end zone. Touchdown, Illinois.
A 9-yard touchdown run from number two, Nathan Schielhaus.
Take a look at it again. First rushing touchdown of the career of Nathan Schielhaus.
Hey, if you're going to work one time, do the same play again.
And the extra point by Derek Dimke is good. Impressive start for the Fighting Illini of Illinois on their first possession of the afternoon as they motor to the end zone. And the quarterback, Nathan Schielhaus, over the top for the touchdown.
Big Ten Network Football is presented by the United States
NFL Sunday.
Wayne Larrabee, Mohsin Mohammed back at Champaign. Principal Financial Group, edge of the game for Illinois coach Ron Zook. What do you see?
Well, you know, they're going to have to control the line of scrimmage, and they showed that on the first drive. I mean, it was evident. And, you know, we had Mikhail Lashore for a couple big plays, Nathan Shieldhouse for a couple of big runs, and they capped it off with a touchdown at the end.
Derek Dimke on the kickoff. 7-0 Illinois early going, and another good strong kick into the end zone. Davis downs it. It'll be first and 10 coming out at the 20-yard line for Northern Illinois. Let's go back to the touchdown, Moose.
All right, look at Shieldhouse right here. Excuse me, Mikhail Lashore. He's going to fake this play right here, and Shieldhouse is going to keep it. Fake that, and now Shieldhouse is going to go over the top. Huh? You got to like that right there. The effort, the leadership to score a touchdown on the opening drive. Great play by Shieldhouse, and I can see why they're so excited about this young athlete. Right?
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, they were excited about him last week because he was completing passes. He was 7-for-7 in the second half passing last week. You saw the drive, most of it on the ground, open for Illinois. Now Northern Illinois, Chandler Harnish looking to answer. Chad Spann, and so far the Illinois front, especially the linebacking core, has been very effective. Martez Wilson, the junior out of Chicago, who missed 11 games last season due to a neck injury and has been shaking off the rust the first two games of the season all over that play.
Yeah, I'd like to see him get off to a great start. The coaches say he is one of the freak athletes on his team, and he has the ability to make such great athletic plays, and it's good to see him getting off to a great start.
Loss of 2, second and 12. Harnish empties the shotgun. That's Kreider in motion. Harnish looking that way. Off the hands of the intended receiver, Nathan Palmer. Second, make it third down coming up and long for Northern Illinois. If you're looking for another Big Ten Network game, go to BigTenNetwork.com/GameFinder to get the channel numbers for all of today's games. Fighting Illini. In the early going had the edge on their rivals from the north, the Northern Illinois Huskies. Now third down and 12 for Northern Illinois. Offensive coordinator Matt Linegrover, this is exactly what he could not afford to be, is behind the chains with his team. Harnish afforded good protection to start. Over the middle, he's got more, and he has the first down across the 30-yard line. Martell Moore, sophomore from San Antonio, Texas, but it was the protection that allowed that crossing pattern to happen.
Moore is just going to sneak underneath the formation right here and catch the ball. He does a great job of getting up the field, and he has that big play and speed potential. Look for him on some post routes.
Looked like Illinois was in a zone there, right? Bellamy just let him go to the next zone, right?
Yeah, they just let him go, and he just creeps underneath that zone, catches the ball, and gets up the field. That's what you got to do.
First and 10, 31-yard line. This is Kreider. Spann unable to get much going on the first drive, and they go to Kreider on this one, and he picks up barely a yard. Illinois much improved under Vic Koenig, the defensive coordinator, giving up just 72 yards rushing per contest. Their 17 tackles for loss leads the Big Ten after the first 2 weeks of the season. There's Vic right there. What a job he's done.
The enforcer is what they call him on the staff and the team. He's an impressive guy.
Second and long for Northern Illinois. Only their second possession of the afternoon. Harnish alone in the shotgun gets motion and goes that way. Good hit made on the sidelines. That was the youngster, Jasmine Hopkins, the junior college transfer. Justin Green with a hit. Let's listen.
There's some hard hitting going on today. I tell you what, they love the weight room, this defense here. And with Vic Koning's mentality of do it my way, they're adapting that. And you can see it. You can see these guys really buying into that.
Gain of about 7 on the play. Leaves third down and about 3. A little bit less than 3. Harnish. The keeper straight ahead, and it pops wide open into Illinois territory to the Illini 42-yard line. Chandler Harnish on the keep. Tavon Wilson made the tackle.
The most important part of this play is the fake. Watch the defense. And then look at this hole right here. That's a huge hole. But the fake is the thing that sold it, that gave Harnish the ability to go straight up that hole and pick up big yardage.
18-yard scamper by Harnisch, who was outstanding, as we mentioned earlier, with 178 yards rushing in that win over North Dakota a week ago. First and 10. Kreider is the running back. They get motion from the tight end to the backfield. Harnisch looks for the air off play action. Oh, he's got a man wide open down the middle. Palmer to the end zone, and it is down to the 1 yard line. Number 41 yards to the doorstep for the Huskies.
Big play right down the middle of the field. The play action sells it with the fake, and the middle of the field is wide open. I don't know if they were in a zone or man on that, but the middle of the field was wide open right there, and Nathan Palmer executes perfectly.
And Nate Bussey, he left Nate in his wake, and Bussey hustled back to deny. And here's Kreider reaching inside, just inside the one, but short of the goal line. So second down and goal to go. Northern Illinois. Coach Jerry Kill sends on some new personnel. And they've loaded up front. Double tight ends on the line. Span, the tail of the tandem in the eye. Flahive is the fullback. Landon Cox, the lone wide receiver, bottom of your screen. And over the top, straight ahead, the touchdown for Chad Span.
Chad Span says, you know what? I can go over the top too. And comes right back at this Illinois defense and goes right up the gut. They bring Flahive in as the lead blocker. And he gets an opportunity to go over the top. Watch the rise over the top in the end zone. Touchdown.
Well, this is surprising. Northern Illinois going for two. And look at this formation. Harnisch to the flat and right through the hands of his intended receiver, Jack Marks. The Illini reacted as if it was a live ball. They thought maybe a lateral and that would be a fumble, but it was not. It's an incomplete pass through the hands of Jack Marks, the tight end. Northern Illinois on this dive into the end zone by Chad Span, back to within one.
Ball in 60, Monday through Wednesday at 10 Eastern on the Big Ten Network.
Well, something for the visitors from DeKalb, Illinois to cheer about here. Their Northern Illinois ball club drove 80 yards in 9 plays. Harnisch an 18-yard run on third down to kind of spark it into Illinois territory. Then the 42-yard pass play to Nathan Palmer put him at the doorstep. Getting set to kick it away. Michael Klimovsky, they call him the lawyer, his Northern Illinois teammates. And twin safeties back deep, Jack Ramsey, the principal return man for Illinois. Klimovsky was the kickoff man here at Illinois for 3 years, graduated, is now in law school at Northern Illinois, had a year of eligibility left, and Ron Zook let him out of his commitment and allowed him to play Northern Illinois. This is Malines. And, oh, good coverage. Penalty marker down, but good coverage on that play by Cameron Stingley, a linebacker on the tackle. Penalty marker down.
Cameron Stingley, there is a flag on the play.
Dennis Lipsky.
Illegal block in the back. Number 42 of the receiving team. That's a 10-yard penalty. First down.
So this will back up the Illini. Now, Moose, let's go back to the big play in that last drive, the 42-yard pass play to Palmer. This is tough duty for the Bandit out there, or the strong side linebacker safety, Nate Bussey, the nickelback.
Yeah, Nate Bussey right here. There's a mismatch that Lime Grover, the offensive coordinator, takes advantage of. He has a speed guy, Nathan Palmer, on him in man-to-man coverage, and he takes advantage of it for the big play. Almost a touchdown on that play.
Nate Bussey is the outside linebacker, strong safety type player, and that's the mismatch that Northern Illinois wants to get. He plays behind the Bandit defender on the defensive line for Illinois. Illinois backed up off that penalty. Not much there for Shieldhouse this time. Kind of feeling the defense could be looking for number two on some of those play fakes. Now Devon Butler, the linebacker in the middle of that defense, responding.
Yeah, fool me once, shame on you. And you're not going to fool me twice. And they were ready for Nathan Shieldhouse on that particular play.
Well, he fooled him about three times on that first drive. So I think you're right. There were some adjustments made during that last defensive timeout. First down. I make it second down now for Shieldhouse and company. Lots of time. And it's dropped by LeSure across the 10-yard line. Underneath the coverage of Tyrone Clark. Now for the Auto Owners Insurance starting defense. Jake Kaufman, 26-year-old redshirt senior, a former Marine Corps corporal, is the leader up front, as you might expect. Alex Kuba, Devon Butler, Tyrone Clark, very quick linebackers. And then Tracy Williams starting in that secondary along with Rashawn Melvin. Beg your pardon, Sean Melvin and Patrick George starting in that secondary on the corners. Tracy Wilson and Tommy Davis at the safeties. Illinois now facing third down and 10. Shieldhouse steps up and steps into traffic. Excellent collapse of the pocket up front for Northern Illinois, and they brought the pressure. Joe Windsor closed it down from his defensive end spot.
Yeah, he does a great job of containing. And I think the key is going to be to control the line of scrimmage. I talked a little bit about that, but they have to do a great job of adding pressure to him, but also containing him, and that's a tough responsibility.
So now punting situation for Illinois. Tommy Davis back in single safety. Anthony Santella leads the Big Ten, ranked second in the NCAA. With a 49-yard average, which could use 49 yards on this one for sure, and gets a beautiful putt away. Davis from his 39. Trying to get the corner. He cannot. Boy, I tell you what. They lined up the blue-clad defenders like a picket fence straight across the field. There is a penalty marker down. Aaron Gress and Justin Staples led the way on the coverage.
Number 20, Tommy Davis with the return.
Penalty marker down.
Flag on the play.
Davis had nowhere to go.
Tackle on the play by number
Jerry Kill, an unusual week for him. As we mentioned, spent most of the week at Northwestern Hospital in Chicago.
During the kick, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 72 of the kicking team at the 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
Egregious error made by Hugh Thornton in Northern Illinois. When we come back, we'll start in Illinois territory at the Illini 44-yard line. Illinois by the slimmest of margins.
First is the first 4G phone.
Taste and textures in every handful of Chex Mix. We're made to mix.
The United States Marine Corps salutes today's leader of the game, Illinois punter Anthony Santella. A 2010 Campbell Trophy watch list candidate. The Campbell Trophy is given to the nation's top scholar athlete, referred to as the Academic Heisman. Santella, three-time academic All-Big Ten student, and ranked second to the nation, averaging 49 yards a punt. Just had a 56-yard punt from his own end zone, but a penalty on Illinois.
He's wearing
Northern Illinois to move into Illini territory.
He's wearing a pretty good-looking number there, too. I must.
You like that number?
I like the 87.
You're a little familiar with that number.
I wore that thing and looked good. I haven't seen a punter wearing it.
Yeah. It looks better a wide receiver, but he looks pretty good in it. On the move, Jasmine Hopkins. And fighting his way into a crowd. Just inside the 40. Let's go to Dave Revson in the studio for a Discover Game Break.
Okay, Wayne, updating you on Ohio State and Ohio University. Terrell Pryor and the Bucks off to a good start. Pryor hits Brandon Sain here. Fifth touchdown pass of the year for Pryor. Is yet to throw a pick. Buckeyes on top, 10-0.
Thank you, Dave. Second down for Northern Illinois. Second at about 5. Span in motion. Harnish over the middle. Moore makes the catch. Right there is Ian Thomas, the linebacker. Gain of barely a yard to the 37-yard line of Illinois. Third down coming up for the Huskies.
I think both teams are starting to settle in right now. You see Ian Thomas there making the tackle. It was the same play prior on the prior drive where Martell Moore tried to leap underneath the coverage, and this time they make that adjustment.
Absolutely. Third down for Northern Illinois. third and about four. Chad Spann alongside of Harnish in the shotgun. They get motion from Scarb, the fullback. Harnish fakes the pass, takes it on the run, got a first down and more to the 20, to the house. Touchdown, Northern Illinois.
Cameron Harnish, the ball carrier, rushes for a Northern Illinois touchdown.
NIU scampers into the lead.
37-yard touchdown run.
Chandler Harnish, 37-yard touchdown run.
The key right here to this big play is the block by Kyle Scarb, number 34, springs Harnish for the touchdown.
Extra point from Matthew Sims. And it hit the right upright. Well, they missed on a two-point conversion on their first scoring drive, and they miss on a PAT here, but a penalty marker down. And let's see if he gets a reprieve. Don't think so.
There are two fouls on the play. Personal foul, number 94, on the defense.
All right, thank you, Dennis. But this was successful. 37-yard run to the lead by Chandler Harnish.
We're made to mix. First-timers.
Wayne Larrabee along with former Michigan State standout Mohsin Mohammed back in Champaign. Quick scoring drive, and Chandler Harnish carried the mail for 37 yards and a touchdown.
Yeah, anytime you see a big play that goes for a touchdown, typically there's a key block. This block right here on Trevor Bellamy by Kyle Scarb. Gets in great position right there to spring Chandler Harnish for the touchdown.
Harnish went right behind that block. You're right, they got a great seal off that side. But the play fake boost, does that do anything to freeze the defense where, you know, he came up when he first got the ball, he faked to his right like he was going to throw it?
Absolutely. They call that the Statue of Liberty. And that's one of the play fakes that you typically use when you're going to run a quarterback draw.
Klamovsky's kickoff. Malines from his three. Upended by Delegal across the 20, out near the 25-yard line. Well, the Huskies are fired up, there's no doubt about that. Two touchdown drives on their last two possessions. They got the lead here as we head to the later stages of this first quarter.
Sets up first and 10, Illinois, from its own 25-yard line.
Shieldhouse back hit at quarterback. Made huge strides from week one to week two. Big Ten Freshman of the Week for his performance against Southern Illinois. 14 of 18 passing, 229 yards and a couple of touchdowns. First and 10. Here's LeShore. Slips through. Pulling his way to a first down out to the 40-yard line.
LeShore
on a 15-yard ramble.
Big play here by Mikhail. LeShore shows a little muscle running somebody over. Lowers the shoulder right there and takes it to Tommy Davis.
Yeah, he ran a couple of people over on that particular play.
Yeah, I guess somebody else could have took ownership of getting run over right there, but it's just a fabulous run by Mikhail LeShore. Attitude.
798 yards rushing since October 23rd of last year. LeShore again, the workhorse up the middle, a little pile drive boot for a gain of two. Stay tuned. We will have more from Champaign, but let's go to Dave Repsit in the studio for a Discover game break.
Thank you, Wayne. Michigan trailing early against UMass, but Michael Shaw puts them on top with a touchdown plunge. 7-3 Wolverines. Denard Robinson has thrown his first interception of the year.
Thank you, Dave. Illinois back to the attack. Shieldhouse upended on a keeper around the end, just short of the first down, out near the 48-yard line. Patrick George, the cornerback, up to make the hit.
And they go to the well one more time. The two plays that were successful on the first drive, they come right back and run that fake to Mikhail LeSure, Nathan Shieldhouse around left end.
LeSure in the backfield. And they've got the fullback as well, Jay Prosh. Good-looking freshman out of Mobile, Alabama. Shieldhouse wanted to go the other way with it. Now able to elude defenders in the backfield and is cut down across the 50 in Northern Illinois territory near the 45 of the Huskies with a first down.
Nathan Shieldhouse originally wanted to go to his tight end. I think it was Justin Lattimore. As you see him roll out here, he looks back to the left, and it's not open. So what do? You make something happen with your feet. That's the it factor that I talked about. Nathan Shieldhouse over the top this time, one more time for the first down. Keep the drive moving.
First and 10 at the 45 of Northern Illinois. Jason Ford in the offensive backfield. Shieldhouse keeps it. Caught by Butler, and he's got running room, cutting it back. Inside the 30, Shieldhouse been a slippery fella out there to get a hold of for the Huskies. Stephen O'Neill makes the hit, and Illinois moves the chains once again.
It's the it factor showing up again. He fakes the ball on the play action there, but he keeps it this time. No pass. I'm just going to run it, and I'm going to take it right to you. Great job by Nathan Shieldhouse of controlling the line of scrimmage.
18-yard gain. Illinois moving smartly on offense here. Here's Ford. Big hole up the middle. Ford is hit in the hole, however. And down he goes. Nice tackle made by the safety, Tommy Davis. Stay tuned for the Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report with scores and highlights from today's game, including Ohio at number 2, Ohio State. Illinois second down upcoming. Second and about 4 off the gain of 6. Nathan Shieldhouse, the redshirt freshman at the controls. Ford hit at the line of scrimmage. That was Mike Krause, a redshirt senior out of Germantown, Wisconsin, who made the hit. Penalty marker down on the near sidelines, however.
He is really getting into a groove right now and feeling himself on this drive.
When we talk about quarterbacks, Moose, and rhythm, we generally talk about the passing game, but he seems to be in a rhythm in the running game.
Absolutely, and you know, he's that dual threat. He can make plays with his feet. He can also make plays with his pass, and I'm looking for A.J. Jenkins pretty soon here to make a big play.
Dennis Lipsky will have the call for us here in a moment.
Illegal formation, five players in the backfield. That penalty is declined, third down.
So Northern Illinois will force a third down for Illinois. Third and 6.
They
got it at the 23-yard line of Northern Illinois. Two receivers bottom of your screen, one to the top. That's A.J. Jenkins at the top. Usually the favorite receiver, I should say, of Shieldhouse. Blitz coming. Shieldhouse, nice throw. Faison's got it. And goes to the turf at the 16-yard line where he's got a first down. Underneath the coverage of Tracy Wilson.
Yeah, every now and then you're going to have to make a play with someone in your face. And here's that it factor showing up once again. Can you take a hit, deliver the ball on time? Nathan Shieldhouse is maturing as a quarterback for this team.
Gain of 7. First and 10 just inside the 16 of Northern Illinois. LeSure back in the offensive backfield. And he's got it. Krause again played off of his block to make the hit. And virtually no gain. Second down and 10.
Got to keep the defense honest. And although you're going to run the ball with Nathan Shieldhouse, you're going to throw the ball as well. You got to run it with Mikhail LeSure and Jason Ford. Just to keep them honest. Get ready for that play action fake.
Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report. Scores and highlights of today's game coming up. Right now, we've got a timeout on the field. First quarter in the books in Champaign. The visitors from DeKalb lead the home standing Fighting Illini 12-7 at the end of 1.
What if we told you there's a new utility vehicle out there with the most advanced engine in its class?
The State Farm Wrap-Up, immediately after the game, only on the Big Ten Network.
The Huskies play on the lead, 12-7, as we get set for the second quarter. Wayne Larrabee, along with former Michigan State standout Mohsin Mohammed. Moose, anything that really surprised you? We knew we'd have a competitive game, but anything surprise you in general?
Well, nothing really surprised me. I mean, we knew that both of these teams were competitive. They both like to run the ball, and I think Vic Cohen expressed that it concerned him that, you know, this team could really run the ball with Harnish and Span and all the different things that they do there.
Running the football, not just with running backs, but these quarterbacks have been keys to that running attack both ways. Shieldhouse now to second down and 10 as we begin the second quarter, and whistles hold up the play. Penalty marker down. False start.
False start. Number 8. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
That is a no-no. As a wide receiver, you're always taught to look at the football.
Penalties beginning to be a factor now for Illinois. They've had a couple of penalties that have hurt. You hate to get penalties inside the red zone like that. Now they're back at the 21-yard line on second and 15. Jenkins at the top of your screen. Ramsey, who was a quarterback last week, is at the bottom. Shieldhouse on that shovel pass to LeShore. Moose, I got to tell you something. I've seen this a lot, these shovel passes. It looks like a dangerous play. It's really not, because if the ball is mishandled or it's just dropped by the running back or the receiver, it's a forward pass, not a fumble. But, boy, you throw it into a lot of traffic there, don't you?
Yeah, and, you know, that might have been the safest play for Nathan Shieldhouse, is just to get rid of the ball and just throw it at his feet. It really wasn't anything there.
I mean, one of those defenders gets a handle on it, and they can go the other way. Now third down. Shieldhouse afforded good protection. Now he takes off. Tried to leap for the first down and hammered out of bounds. Tommy Davis responding from the secondary. Let's go to Dave Rebsa to the studio for a Discover Game Break.
Thank you, Wayne. Looking at quarterbacks on the run. How about Terrell Pryor? Touchdown pass earlier. Touchdown run here. The Buckeyes rolling up 17-0 on Ohio University.
Thank you, Dave. 25-yard field goal attempt here for Derek Dimke. Hit a 52-yarder career long against Missouri 2 weeks ago. Santella, the holder. And the kick is good.
Field goal is good.
Illinois back to within two in the opening minute of this, the second quarter. Ron Zook and company, they knew they'd be in a dogfight with a bunch of Huskies from DeKalb.
Big Ten Network football is brought to you in part by
First Timers, Old Pros, Heated Rivals. You can't do the wave by yourself. And just like we mix and mingle, so do the delicious tastes and textures in every handful of Chex Mix. We're made to mix.
It spells Go Illini. I don't think you could spell it any better than that. Text keyword Rotel to 20284 to enter the Rotel Feed Their Game Face sweepstakes. Winner will receive 52 weeks worth of groceries and a trip to a college football game. Message and data rates may apply. Text STOP to quit. Three penalties, 30 yards against Illinois in this first half of play. No penalties yet on the Huskies. Those penalties have either given Northern Illinois some good field position to start a drive, or in the case of Illinois in that last drive, moved them back from the 10-yard line back to the 15 and, in effect, denied them a touchdown opportunity. Here's the kickoff into the end zone once again. And, boy, Dempke's been very solid. 4 yards deep on each kickoff here this afternoon. A third touchback of the game. Go interactive. Play along with every Big Ten football game this season on the Big Ten Network with the Big Ten Blast Game. Presented by Rotel and Velveeta Famous Queso Dip. Predict plays, answer trivia, compete, and chat with friends for a chance to win the ultimate tailgate package. Sign up now to play the Big Ten Blast only at BigTenNetwork.com. Jerry Kill, I mentioned he spent the week in a Chicago hospital. Complications due to surgery after the first game of the season. He did not coach his team during the week, but his coordinators have been with him for a long time. And they know the drill, so to speak. Coach Kill has battled cancer in his coaching career and won that battle. And this was another week where they had to make some adjustments. First down play, not much there. Matt Limegrover has been with Coach Kill for 10 years, and defense coordinator Tracy Clay's going on his 15th season. So they certainly, I don't imagine anything was missed in the preparation of this football team just because the head coach wasn't there.
Yeah, and absolutely. And Coach Kill is a warrior, man. I mean, you don't have to question his dedication to this football team and being the head coach and being the leader.
They're the coaches. Coach Kill, an outstanding staff. They turned around that Southern Illinois program, and they're doing the same thing at Northern Illinois, trying to extend the success and build on the success Joe Novak had in DeKalb. Chandler Harnish on the loose again. Got a first down to the 32-yard line.
Anytime he gives you that Statue of Liberty look, yeah, he may be thinking pass, but if you go, let's go back to the replay here. Here's the Statue of Liberty look. Now, he's just going to tuck the ball and run it. I think on that particular play, it was designed for a pass play, but he saw a cavity in the defense and took advantage of it.
Moose, does he have a run-pass option on that necessarily or not?
Yeah, I think so. And you know, they covered it quite well. The defense covered it quite well, and he just tucked the ball and ran that time.
A lot of times they'll design plays for run-pass option. Not sure on that one, but and a handoff to the running back, not much there, and a straight ahead move up the middle. Jasmine Hopkins, he's the change of pace back, a junior college transfer out of Stanley, North Carolina.
Chandler Harnish has got to do a better job of carrying out the fake on that play. He handed the ball off that time to Hopkins, and he looked back and almost stared at him, and you know, he's not going to pull a defender off by doing that.
Gain of 3, second and 7. Got the pistol look for Northern Illinois. They call it shot. Harnish. Merciless with the pass rush pressure. Good play by Whitney Merciless. Let's go to Dave Rebson in the studio. Discover Game Break.
Thank you, Wayne. Very quiet at the big house right now. Jonathan Hernandez goes in for UMass. The Minutemen leading the Wolverines 10-7, second quarter.
Surprise working up in Ann Arbor. Long way to go in these games. Third down and 7 for Northern Illinois. Three man down line for the Illini defensively. Harnish in the gun. Underneath to the tight end, Jack Marks, short of the first down. Gain of 5, it's fourth down and 2.
It's a bend don't break style of defense, and what you really want to do is just get off of the field right here. And so, you know, Illinois, they need to make some stops right here in order to get back in this football game, give their team, give their offense a chance to explode again for a big play.
Josh Wilbert in punt formation, a junior from Phoenix, Arizona. That's Jack Ramsey, number 19, back deep for Illinois. Ramsey retreats, makes a fair catch signal, makes the catch inside the 10-yard line. They mark it at the 9. Illinois starts deep in its own territory, trailing by 2 at home.
The Big Ten Press Pass, presented by Sprint, Tuesdays on the Big Ten Network.
Encased in bronze outside the stadium, the most famous of the Illini, Harold Red Grange, the Galloping Ghost, the game's greatest all-time offensive player, member of the Pro and College Halls of Fame. Red's most memorable performance, October 18, 1924. He scored 4 touchdowns in the first 18 minutes against Michigan. The first 18 minutes in the history of Memorial Stadium, the dedication game. He later ran for a 5th and threw a 6-yard touchdown pass. Harold Red Grange. But you didn't know his first name was Harold.
No, I just call him the Galloping Ghost, man.
He's calling him the Ghost.
I know Howard Griffith has 8 touchdowns for this Illini team, which is an NCAA record.
Yes, he does.
Yeah.
Against SIU years ago. James in motion. Illinois starting this drive at their 9-yard line. LeSure buried inside. Alan Baxter got over to make the hit.
Alan Baxter has a motor that doesn't quit. I watched him play the last couple of weeks, and this guy really, really can get it done on that front line. And he'll give that offensive line the flux this game, and he'll be a great player for them.
Sophomore out of Buffalo Grove, Illinois, Alan Baxter. No gain for the Illini. Shieldhouse second down and 10. That's LeShore in the offensive backfield. Here comes LeShore around the end. Gets the corner to the 10. A good take on by Rashawn Melvin. That's a strong tackle on a big running back by a cornerback.
Yeah, you're talking about 186 pounds versus 230 pounds. And I'm going to show you what it looks like right here as he comes across that edge, right? He lowers the shoulder. Oh, good square tackle. Go for the knees. Go for the legs. Don't take him up high.
Low man always wins in this game, doesn't he?
Low man wins. You got that right.
Third down, Illinois. Illini with kind of a muddle huddle, calling the play at the line. Shieldhouse going over the top. Jenkins broken up beautifully right in front of the NIU bench. Oh, what a play made by Patrick George.
Patrick George is their best cover guy. That's what Clacy, the defensive coordinator, stated. And you can see it right here. I'm going to put my best guy on your best guy. A.J. Jenkins, that leads the team with 147 receiving yards and two touchdowns, gets shut down on that play.
Patrick George didn't play the first week of the season off an ankle injury during camp. He returned last week, and he looks to be in fine form now. Confirmation time. Santella, again, just did get this one away. Kind of a line drive kick. Davis fields it. And Davis unable to make the 40-yard line. Brought down just short of the Northern Illinois 40. But good field position for the Huskies to start this next drive. Almost 5 minutes gone by, second quarter. And Northern Illinois leading by two. Starting today, the Big Ten Network unveils a new series that counts down the top athletes in the conference's rich history. Today we unveil number 20, former Michigan great and Heisman Trophy winner Charles Woodson. Big Ten Icons, hosted by Keith Jackson, premieres today, 4 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network. Moose, you and I had a chance to see that first show on that particular series, and what an outstanding job they did in putting that together. And Charles Woodson revealed some things, and so did Coach Lloyd Carr, that I think you'll find enjoyable. First and 10 for Northern Illinois. This is Hopkins. Trying to get around the end, but I'll tell you what, the pursuit, both sides have been pretty good here this afternoon. Gain of 3 on that play. Corey Legit from the defensive line got over to make the hit.
Yeah, the first guy to the ball here is Marcellus, and he does a great job of just delaying him a little bit and let his buddies come and join him for the party. You know, you got to tie him up a little bit, and they do a good job of pursuing and getting to that tackle.
There's Vic Koning, defensive coordinator. 4 years at Clemson, his defense finished in the top 25 at NCAA scoring total and pass efficiency defense each season. They're doing a heck of a job with the ground troops here at Illinois, giving up just 72 yards a game rushing so far. Spann trying to get to the outside. Bussey out in front of that play. Wilson was also there. A late flag thrown.
This defense is getting very stingy. Vince Koning has got these guys inspired. My way or the highway is what he says.
Personal foul. Face mask on the defense. That's a 15-yard penalty, but an automatic first down.
Let's see if we can pick up the face mask penalty here.
There it is.
Yeah, it's more than just incidental. He took him down with the hand there and rode him to the ground as he had his hands on his face mask. Yeah, that's going to be a 15-yard penalty every single time.
And as you saw a moment ago, there are 4 penalties against Ron Zook's defense.
45 yards.
Significant.
Yeah, and you know, that's a stat that shows up later on that can definitely hurt you.
Northern Illinois now first and 10 at the Fighting Illini 43. Harnish. Wilson, the linebacker, read it nicely. Martez Wilson, the junior from Chicago, Illinois, perhaps the most gifted of the Illini linebackers.
It's a good job of balling up right there. And that's the same Statue of Liberty play that Harnish has hit for a couple big plays on him throughout the course of this game. And that time, nothing happened.
Yeah, he's creased him a couple of times, including a 37-yard touchdown run earlier. Second down and 10. But this has been a much improved defensive front for Illinois. and the coach Koenig. Heinisch on the cross over the middle. Stumbling grab made by Landon Cox, the senior from Calumet City, Illinois. Down to the 36-yard line. A gain of 7, third down and 3 upcoming.
Yeah, Cox is definitely the leader of that offensive receiving core. And they got to give him the ball a bit more. I mean, he has these matchups that are mismatches, I guess you want to call them mismatches. And he does a great job of running after the ball, running after the catch. So I think they got to do a better job of getting the ball in his hands throughout the course of this game.
Span is the tailback in the pistol look. Harnish on third down to Span off the right side. It looked like they had a seal, but they could not clean up the backside. And the bandit, Clay Nurse, from that defensive end spot, able to break it down. Gain of 1, fourth and 2.
Yeah, it's decision time right now, and I think they've been struggling with that kicking game for NIU. They have a freshman kicker, Sims, and they've been struggling a little bit, so they're going to try to go for it here on the fourth down and 1 or 2 here.
Well, let's see what Harnish has up his sleeve here. Crowd comes to full throat. Fourth down for the Huskies. Fourth and 2 at the Illini 35. Hopkins, did he make it? It appears he's close, but I'm not sure they're going to give him the line to gain.
Jasmine Hopkins, the ball carrier.
Talked about controlling the line of scrimmage, and the defense for Illinois is doing a great job of doing that right now. It may be close, but I'm not sure if they got this first down. They put two running backs in the game. I think that's Hopkins that they handed the ball off to. Chad Spann is providing the decoy, if you want to speak there. And I'm not sure if he got that first down. It's going to be close.
Trulon Henry came in from his free safety spot, Moose, and made a key hit early on that run by Hopkins. And let's see if the Illini defense is held on fourth down. They have. So Ron Zook and company respond on fourth and short. Jerry Kill's defense will head back onto the field with 6:49 left to go, second quarter. Zook and the Illini down 2.
Lights only on the Big Ten Network.
In primetime tonight, the Hoosiers hit the road to battle Western Kentucky. Coverage starts at 5 Eastern in HD on the Big Ten Network. Western Kentucky trying to snap an extended losing streak, Moose. Maybe that's understating it a little bit. But Indiana certainly has had its way on the ground against Western Kentucky in that series. First and 10, Illinois. They start this drive at their 34-yard line, trailing by 2, second quarter. LeShore, Malone setback, and he's coming around the end. Got a good block from Faison and has first down yardage across the 45-yard line to the 46 on a gain of 11 yards.
Evan Wilson does a great job here of sealing the edge. And as you see him, if we can pause it right there, guys. There you go right there. And he does a great job of sealing that edge and allowing Mikel LeShore to get around the corner for a big game.
And downfield, the wide receiver held his block as well, Jared Faison. Ford in that backfield behind Shieldhouse. On first and 10, play action, quick toss. Jenkins makes the first man miss. Alex Kuba brings him down to the 40-yard line. Inside Husky territory. First and 10, Illinois, 14-yard pickup.
When you get the ball in your hands, what you have to do is catch it and get up the field, breaking tackles right there. A.J. Jenkins is starting to get in his zone a little bit here and getting more comfortable. I think he's a little bit upset. Patrick George on the coverage in the last series. I think he just got the best of him, but he's going to come back and make his presence felt.
All start, number 73, offense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Hang in there, big fella. Hang in there. Left guard, and that's all it takes. Just a little bit of movement. And they're going to see that, and it just it triggers a whole domino effect here. But, you know, you just got to sit in there.
It's hard to hold your water that long when you're that big, you know. I'm telling you.
Absolutely, absolutely. And then you just sit there like, hey, maybe nobody really saw me.
Yeah, really. Tight end motions to the right, and here comes LeSure around that end. And a pickup of a couple of yards on first and 15.
Paul Petrino likes to dial up the same play over again if he has success on it. And you see that again. They tried to seal the edge again with Evan Wilson.
It's your guy, Evan Wilson, yep.
He's an athletic guy, too. Big guy.
True freshman.
6'6", 240. And comes from Woodstock, Georgia. They really like this kid. He made a big play in the game last week and caught a little bit of flack from his teammates for not scoring on it.
You saw Paul Petrino there. He said, you know, one of the reasons he came to Illinois was that Ron Zook's a defensive guy. He's going to get to run his offense here. Shieldhouse trying to shake loose. Cannot. Oh, outstanding play made by D.J. Perkle to hang on to the elusive quarterback.
Yeah, trips up Shieldhouse a little bit here. He gives a Statue of Liberty look and then gets tripped up a little bit. Can't quite get out of that tackle. And now you're going to get a third down and long situation. Not very good.
Third and about 14. Football just inside the 45 of Northern Illinois. Shieldhouse calling the play from the backfield. Three receivers, top of your screen. That's Jenkins on the bottom. Plenty of time. Shieldhouse directing traffic. Incomplete. Oh, my goodness. Malines was shoved on the play, and boy, they didn't have to do that. Kyrie Daniels pushed the Illinois receiver. That pass was well overthrown. The officials are conferring.
Yeah, I'm going to call that a bailout play because there was nothing there. I mean, it was great coverage. He had great coverage. He didn't even have to touch Malines.
We'll see it
again. You got to play smart there. You know what? In those situations, Wayne, you got to be smarter.
Pass interference. Number 23, defense. That's a 15-yard previous spot with an automatic first down.
Moose, let's take a look at it. Good point, because Kyrie Daniels didn't have to push the receiver here.
He didn't, and, you know, they do a great job of making Nathan Shieldhouse scramble to his left. He likes to scramble to his right. But if you look there, the ball was uncatchable. And you know, Kyrie Daniels, if he lays off right there, the ball sails out of bounds. And now you get the ball on the punt.
And now Illinois gets it first and 10, 29-yard line of Northern Illinois. First penalty against the Huskies here today. A costly one. Penalty markers all over the play. Jason Ford got back to the line of scrimmage, and that was about it. Jake Kaufman, D.J. Perkle, all over that play on the defensive front.
Holding number 66, offense. 10-yard penalty will repeat. First down.
NIU is coming back now, attempting to control the line of scrimmage with penetration. 58 Mike Krause right there, getting into the backfield, disrupting the play, forcing the running back to bounce outside. This is going to be a key factor in this game. Who is going to control the line of scrimmage? This is an attitude type of game.
Illinois came in two games, committed 11 penalties, 99 yards against them. That's their fifth penalty today, if I'm not mistaken. First and long. Shieldhouse to the flat. Ford stiff arms his way past one man, got by Kuba, and then down it goes to the hand of Rashawn Melvin.
Muscle. And that's all the coaching staff and his co-workers, his players, they just look at this guy as a weight room guy, just pushes him over, almost knocks two guys down like a bowling pins there.
That's a gain of 11, and now makes it second down and about 9. Shieldhouse with Ford in the backfield. Jenkins at the top of your screen. Shieldhouse looking that way. Jenkins was wide open behind the linebacker coverage, and then George brings him down, but not before the Illini. I have a first down to the 18-yard line of Northern Illinois.
Yeah, I like the way Jenkins catches the ball and gets up the field. He pushes the defensive back off, catches the ball, does a great job of just getting up the field. You got to get what you can take. Take what you can get there on that.
You can't push. He didn't do that. Did he really? They missed that? You can't do that.
No, he didn't push. I mean, he used his eyes to push the defensive back.
Okay. Yeah.
Receivers don't push off.
No, I didn't think so. I never saw you push off.
Never. Absolutely.
Big body of yours, number 87 all over it. My goodness. Overpowering those poor little linebackers and DBs. Shieldhouse to the end zone and overshot Jenkins, who was covered like a glove by Patrick George.
Yeah, they're deciding now to just match up Patrick George with A.J. Jenkins. Mono, Ibano. Good release now. I mean, gets up the field, he squeezes him. Maybe a little bit of a push there, but, you know, George comes back and grabs that arm. You know, I got to see Nathan Shieldhouse keep that ball in bounds. Maybe throw a back shoulder throw on that particular play and give him an opportunity to make an athletic grab.
There's the drive. Again on the 34-yard line of Illinois. Seven plays, 49 yards later, second and 10. LeSure. Able to get to the outside. LeSure tightroping the sidelines inside the 10. And he's out of bounds at the 8-yard line. Von Butler forced him out.
A little shake and bake right there.
Out of bounds by number 9, Devon Butler.
Mikhail LeSure gets outside, gives a little bit of, oh, shake and bake, give you a little something and take it away. Almost getting the first down on that play. And they may measure for it here.
They're going to, it looks to me on the sidelines, they're going to take a close look at it. Just inside the 8-yard line is where they have it spotted. Mikhail LeSure is a junior out of Champaign, went to Centennial High School here in Champaign. And he's had some ups and downs through his collegiate career, but he said this week that, you know, he's matured and his role is, he started to come on last year. I mentioned he really finished the season strong since October 23rd of last season into the first two games of this year. He's rushed for 798 yards. He's added to it today, obviously. The only player in Big Ten over that period of time in Big Ten play that's rushed for more yards is Wisconsin's John Quay.
Yeah, well, Paul Petrino, when I asked him about him, he said Mikhail LeSure is the total package, and one of his most valuable attributes is his vision and his hips, his ability to get in the hole, make people miss, and when he's outside, he still has the ability as a big guy to use those hips to make guys miss. So, you know, he's a valuable weapon for this team.
As you saw a moment ago, Illinois inches short. They face third down. The football just inside the 8-yard line of Northern Illinois. The Illini trying to grab the lead. And there's what I mentioned just a moment ago. The Illini trying to grab the lead here as we head toward halftime. A little over 2 minutes to go, first half.
Just saw a picture of Paul Petrino there. And he says this team has to be a fist. You know, fingers poke at people. But when you ball those fingers up to become a fish, you can knock them out. And right here, they need a knockout punch to get this first down.
Two tight ends for the tailback. Ford to the outside. Breaks a tackle to the end zone. Touchdown!
Touchdown!
Jason Ford on third and inches takes it to the outside, beats the defense to the corner to the pylon, and Illinois into the lead. 8-yard touchdown run.
You know, Jason Ford says, you know what? I can make moves too. I got good hips too. I can make a guy miss. I'm not just a power back. I can take it in the end zone. I like it.
He heard you sending all that love to Mikhail LeSure. He said, hey, big fella, how about a little this way?
He said, hey, there's another starter in this backfield, you know.
Illinois is going to go for two. Jerry Kill just called a timeout from the Northern Illinois sidelines. Illinois, an impressive 9-play, 66-yard drive to the lead score. We got a 16-12 advantage. Looking for the two-point conversion. Now, Jason Ford, a junior out of Belleville, Illinois, last season, Moose averaged 6.1 yards per rushing attempt.
Yeah, and Paul Petrino said that he arguably has the best hands of any of the running backs in that backfield. Now, I dare not say any of the specialist players, because A.J. Jenkins would definitely argue that.
Illinois on the ground has averaged 205 yards rushing since 2006, leading the Big Ten during that span. This is their third offensive coordinator. We've been talking about Paul Petrino, but prior to Paul, Mike Locksley, Mike Schultz were here. Three offensive coordinators in 3 years, but it seems to me, Moose, the one thing they're going to do is run the football and run it effectively. That is almost a staple of what they do, whoever the coordinator might be.
Yeah, and they're going to do it behind the leadership now of Paul Petrino.
So they're going for two. Trying to make it a six-point advantage. Shieldhouse gets motion from Wilson, the tight end. Fakes to LeShore, and it opens up like the Red Sea for Moses for Nathan Shieldhouse. Two-point conversion, and with just under 2 minutes to go in this first half, Illinois has recaptured the lead. The Fighting Illini of Illinois, piloted by Richard freshman Nathan Shieldhouse, lead it by six.
What is the news?
Time to pick up some Illinois garb, I guess, right now. Ringing it up in the pro shop, so to speak, or the college shop. Oh. Stay tuned. Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report, scores and highlights in today's games, including the Ohio State-Ohio game. And we'll have it all for you coming up with the guys in the studio.
Zook them. Is that what they just did on that play? They just zooked them on that two-point conversion. Is that what they did there?
It might have. That's one way of putting it. That's their first two-point conversion since the Missouri game two seasons ago. Jason Ford, boy, really came on tail end of that last drive. Dempke's kickoff. He's put them all in the end zone thus far. This no exception. Tommy Davis exception drops to a knee. First down for Northern Illinois from their 20. They have two timeouts left.
All right, I want to go back to this two-point conversion because we've seen this play two or three times during the course of the game where they faking the ball to Mikhail LeShore, and Nathan Shieldhouse takes it around the left side. They did it out in the field a couple times. They come back to it on the two-point conversion. Paul Petrino feels very comfortable calling that play in big play situations.
What is the key on that play, Moose?
Well, it's the play action. You really need to sell that. And I think Mikhail LeShore, being the run threat, handing him the ball, and he's making big plays, and that sells that fake.
Mm-hmm.
And then Nathan Shieldhouse keeps it and hits that cavity in the defense.
So first and 10 for Northern Illinois.
Quarterback!
Span escaping to the outside for about four. Trulon Henry, who is the brother, former Illini wide receiver, really has been in on that stop.
They're doing a great job of bottling up Chad Spann so far this game. They're really containing him and keeping him to a low yardage, rushing yardage here. So they got to continue to do that if they want to dictate the pace of this game.
You can tell Chad Spann was high up on the scouting report for Illinois. No doubt about that. Spann again. Boy, they've been very solid, it looks to me, Moose, with the backside contained. That time Ashante Williams did a nice job of staying home. The sophomore from Mayfield, Ohio, short gain to the 25. It is third and five.
Yeah, you know, if you keep punching and keep punching and keep punching, you know, the running back is eventually going to get tired of trying to run in the teeth of that defense, and that's what they're doing right now.
Well, they've tried Spann and Hopkins. The most effective runner has been Chandler Harnish. And this quarterback draw plays. Now third and five. Harnish looking downfield, got a man open. Wide open, Landon Cox, the veteran. Ashante Williams made the tackle, but that's a long time to ask a linebacker to cover on that play.
Matt Limegrover said he was going to put an emphasis on getting Cox the football this week, and you can see that right there.
Williams plays that hybrid strong side linebacker or nickel back position, and another quick decisive throw by Chandler Harnish, and this time he drills Martell Moore for first down under the coverage of Tavon Wilson, and suddenly the Huskies are at the midfield marker, and we're under 30 seconds to go in the half.
It's a heavyweight bout. They're trying to keep them off balance here by just coming right out and attacking the defense.
Harnish again to the sidelines, and the catch made. No, they're going to say he did not come down in bounds. Trulon Henry had the coverage on Martell Moore.
That was really, really close, and I'd like to see if he got a foot in on
it
that.
It looked like it from here, but
really close.
And they'll take a look at this
nice,
in the booth.
Nice two-hand grab. Yeah, his foot was on the line there.
Good catch. Didn't quite get that toe inside the white line. Second and 10. Illinois changing up personnel, flipping from one side to the other defensively. 14 seconds to go in the half. Huskies trying to get into field goal range if they can. You run out of time? No, a timeout taken. Northern Illinois gets a timeout called. They were winding the play clock and running out of time.
Now, the thing that's going to come into play here is the kicking game. You're running your two-minute offense. You don't have a whole lot of time. You're getting across that 50-yard mark, and if you get another 20 yards, typically you'd be in position to kick a field goal. But with the freshman as a kicker, you almost feel like it's four-down territory or you got to go in the end zone. It's got to be one of those situations where, you know, you got to try to get 7 points on this drive.
Absolutely. Well, Coach Zook mentioned to us that this was this could be one of those smash-mouth kind of afternoons. He knew the Huskies would come in here and they'd bring their best punch. And Northern Illinois led most of this first half of play. After falling behind, they scored 12 unanswered points. Illinois rallied back into the lead.
They're not going to lay their sword down. You know, either one of these teams, it's a civil battle. You know, in-state rivalries. You could throw all of the stats out the window. We have an in-state rivalry. MAC, Big Ten, doesn't matter. These teams are going to show up trying to beat each other no matter what.
So second down and 10. One timeout left for Northern Illinois. 14 seconds to go in this first half. Nathan Palmer, the man in motion. Harnish screens it out. This is Spann. Broke one tackle attempt. Did not get out of bounds. It goes down near the 39-yard line. With 6 seconds remaining, and Northern has to stop the clock with their final timeout. Staples and Henry on the stop. Now, they've got Michael Klamovsky. And he is their kickoff man and is the guy who tries the long field goals, but I think this one is pretty much out of his range.
Yeah, we had a guy on our team, John Casey, that, you know, when I was a rookie in the NFL, he crossed the 50-yard line and he was golden.
Yes, he was.
I bet they wish they had a John Casey right about now.
Well, obviously here you've got one shot at it. You just take a shot into the end zone.
You may see a jump ball, you know, put three wide receivers on one side, maybe put one guy on the other side and, you know, see if you can get your tallest guy in the game. Maybe they go to, you know, a tight end here, or, you know, Jack Marks, or, you know, he's 6'6", 229, and they say he can stretch the field. Maybe you try to go to him or a trick play, but you don't want to use all your best plays. Save those, keep those in your pocket for the end of the game. But right here, you know, you got to take a shot at the end zone.
It would have been a 57-yard field goal try into the wind here. So they're going to try on first and 10 with 6 seconds to go. They'll try for the end zone. Chandler Harnish in the shotgun. Three receivers top of your screen. Harnish. Can he get it to the end zone against the wind? He does not, and it's broken up incomplete. So a back and forth first half comes to a close. Harnish unable to get the ball into the end zone. Illinois with a 6-point lead at halftime, Moose.
Yeah, it's, I guess, a classic story of David and Goliath here, but we don't know what the outcome is going to be just yet. But we know one thing, the NIU, they came in this ball game with a lot of confidence, and they knew that they had an opportunity to beat this Illinois ball club. And what we've seen now is just a heavyweight bout, a lot of back and forth, a lot of slugging. And right now, Illinois has the best of them, but you know, I'm not sure that they're totally dominating this game. It's pretty even.
Jerry Kill is very upset, and I'm not quite sure what he's asking the official about, but he was asking in rather animated fashion. Take a look at the last play, Moose. See anything here?
Anytime you have a jump ball situation at the end of the half or end of the game, look for pass interference or some kind of pushing and shoving.
Yeah, oh, there it is right there. That's what Coach Kill was talking about.
A little love tap.
You know, and a penalty on the defense would have extended the half to an untimed play.
Yeah, and you know, they would have had the ball. I don't know if they would have had it on the
no.
5 or 6 yard line where that contact took place, but 15 yards.
It would have been pass interference, so right. you'd get so the 15-yard penalty and then put it in play from there.
And put it in play, so another shot at the end zone.
But the half has come to a close here in Champaign.
I think he has a legitimate argument there, but typically, you know, your refs are not going to call those jump ball plays. A lot of contact going on in those plays.
Halftime in Champaign.
It's another perfect chance of driving Gray. Stay inside, hunker down, grab a beer. This is going to be a long one.
Buffalo Wild Wings, you have to be here.
We're receiving reports of hail the size of... Oh, boy.
Most college students change their major before graduation. Not me. I always knew what I wanted to be.
And then I changed majors 8 or 9 times. It's a good thing Illinois has so many options. I wanted to find something that challenged me and stretched my abilities. I may not have succeeded at everything, but all those experiences helped me figure out what I was actually good at.
What are you, a comedian?
Explore Illinois. More choices, more chances to find your passion.
Finally, the show that gives you a voice is here. The Big Ten Pulse, presented by Rotel and Velveeta.
If it's happening in the Big Ten Conference,
it's happening here on the Pulse.
Bold opinions.
What are you going to do now? There's no place to hide.
Strong debates.
Let him coach this team and let him decide what he's good and done.
And your chance to sound off. The Big Ten Pulse, presented by Rotel and Velveeta. Thursday night at 9 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network.
Our goal was to bring something that is going to cure heart defects.
We try to give kids a little bit of direction, a little bit of mentoring. Once they get on their path, you know, they just kind of blossom on their own.
I love helping people, whether it's in Haiti or Africa or just here in Lafayette.
Give Big is a new initiative from the Big Ten Network, recognizing that being part of the Big Ten means giving back to our communities. Check out how Big Ten members are making a difference only on the Big Ten Network.
Inside the Big Ten Film Vault lies a link to yesteryear. Now, the Big Ten Network connects you to the classic moments of previous generations. With special programs presented as they originally aired years ago.
Bringing you on film what we consider the top football thrills of the past season.
I'm Dan Beardorf. Join me as we unlock the treasures of the Big Ten Film Vault. Only on the Big Ten Network.
Welcome in the Buffalo Wild Wings Halftime Report. Dave Revson, Jerry DiNardo, Howard Griffith, Ohio State and Illinois, both with halftime leads, although Ohio State's slightly more comfortable than that the Fighting Illini have in Champaign. Talk about those games in a moment. Let's look at all the highlights. Some interesting games going on throughout the Big Ten. None more interesting than this one. UMass and Michigan. Wolverines trail 3-0 early. Michael Shaw punches it into the end zone. Michigan takes the lead, but UMass would not go away. Down 7-3, Jonathan Hernandez, one of 2 touchdowns in the first half for him. UMass took a 10-point lead at one point, but Michigan battling back. A couple touchdown receptions for Darryl Stoneham. This is the second one. It gives Michigan the lead going into the break at 21-17. Game some of you are watching between Ohio State and Ohio U. 17-0 in favor of the Buckeyes. Terrell Pryor with the touchdown run. 13 yards there. Pryor having a very good first half. He's thrown for 2, run for 1, hits Jake Stoneburner here. And Ohio State cruising up 34-0 at the break. Penn State, Joe Paterno looking for career win number 396, hosting the Golden Flashes of Kent State. Nice pass there from the freshman Rob Bolden to Derek Moy, 55 yards. And from there, the Nittany Lions able to pound it in. Evan Royster with the touchdown run, 14-0 in favor of Penn State. Game some of you are watching between Northern Illinois and the Fighting Illini. Nate Shielhouse just throwing the body all over the place in this game. Launches himself into the end zone. Shielhouse's rush for 84 yards in the first half. Chandler Harnish, another dual threat quarterback, and He goes 37 yards for the touchdown. Northern missed a couple extra points, so 12-7 Huskies, but Illinois comes back behind Jason Ford. From 8 yards out, they got the two-point conversion as well. Illini 18-12 at the break. Purdue and Ball State, no Keith Smith out for the year for the Boilers, but look who's stepping up, the true freshman, O.J. Ross, on the receiving end here from Robert Marv, 36-yard touchdown. Marv's thrown for 106, a little shaken up at the end of the half. Purdue on top, 14-0. So the games we're watching, Ohio State, Illinois, what stands out to you?
Ohio State, certainly a dominating performance, but I still think there's a concern when your quarterback is taking the snap from underneath the center and he's your leading rusher. It may not give Ohio State problems today against Ohio U. I think the tailbacks have to be more involved in the run game.
You look at Illinois' defense, giving up some big plays in Northern Illinois. They're going to have to get that fixed going into the second half, but Nathan Shieldhouse throwing his body all over the place, doing a tremendous job of making plays, but slide, my man. Just slide.
That'll come with time. It's youthful enthusiasm. More halftime coming up.
I'm the fourth string quarterback, but due to a pregame meal of all-you-can-eat calamari, now I'm the first string quarterback. But I'm also a transfer student, so I'm a little lost.
You've got cut-rate insurance, your jacked-up rates might make you sick. So get accident forgiveness from Allstate and be better protected from mayhem, like me.
Dollar for dollar, nobody protects you from mayhem like Allstate.
At Polaris, we designed a trail-dominating legend, the Sportsman XP, to lead a new team of smooth-riding trail runners. We made a versatile, powerful, mid-size Ranger, launching a new group of value-minded workhorses. And we made the ultimate hunting vehicle, the Ranger XP, even better. Heading up a new team of hard-working hunting machines. From the number one maker of ATVs and side-by-sides, Polaris. Hardest working, smoothest riding.
When you add Velveeta to spicy Rotel tomatoes and green chilies, you got a queso so good, it'll blow them away.
Woo!
Dang!
Velveeta and Rotel.
Man, that's good!
This fall, don't just get more out of your tires, get more back from your tires. Because with Cooper's Take the Money and Ride National event, you'll not only get unbeatable performance, you'll get a rebate card by mail when you buy 4 qualifying Cooper tires. Cooper's Take the Money and Ride National event. Get your rebate form and all the terms and conditions at a participating Cooper Tire dealer or at CooperTireRebates.com. Cooper Tires, don't give up a thing.
Welcome in the Buffalo Wild Wings Halftime Report. Dave, Jerry, and Howard with you as we take you through what is a busy day here on the Big Ten Network. Want to remind you of what the schedule will be. As always, the State Farm wrap-up immediately following the game. After that, it is the debut of our new show, Big Ten Icons, the countdown of the top 20 student-athletes in Big Ten history. We start with number 20, the former Wolverine great Charles Woodson. After that, it is the next level with James Laurinaitis. And then more football. Indiana going on the road to Western Kentucky. Matt Devlin and Derek Rackley join us with a preview.
All right, Dave, appreciate it. Rack, if there is a positive between Game 1 and Game 2 and that 16 days that separate them for the Hoosiers is the fact that Tandon Dawes had extra time to rest that groin.
Yeah, I think this entire Hoosier program is really excited to see Tandon Dawes back on the football field. Of course, the number 2 receiver in the conference last year behind Purdue's Keith Smith. But don't expect him to go out and have a huge day. Remember, they've got a host of receivers that Ben Chappell can distribute the ball through. But I'll be expecting him to come out and get maybe 3, 4, or 5 catches to get himself acclimated back to the game.
In game one, Ben Chappell threw to 6 different Hoosiers. And for Indiana, they're going to be looking to start the season 2-0 for the 7th consecutive season. As we send it back to you, Dave.
Guys, thanks. Should be fun. The first ever road football game televised here on the Big Ten Network for a Big Ten team. You see some of the other games. We've got some Big Ten, Pac-10 showdowns, including Iowa, Minnesota, and Wisconsin facing Pac-10 teams. Interesting battle. The only battle of ranked teams today in the nation is Iowa and Arizona, Notre Dame and Michigan State, obviously getting a lot of publicity as well. What jumps out to you, Coach, from those afternoon battles?
The Iowa game at Arizona. When you look at the Iowa team, they're built to run the ball, but at the end of the day, it's going to be Ricky Stanzi throwing the ball against a very difficult run defense by Arizona. Ricky Stanzi had some trouble turning the ball over last year, but, you know, you can't get too uptight about turning the ball over. I mean, it's going to happen. I say this. If Ricky Stanzi can make some big plays in the pass game and limit it to one pick, one turnover, he's okay. It doesn't have to be absolutely perfect in a big game like this, Howard.
You know, you're right. I actually like that Notre Dame-Michigan State, that matchup, particularly when you talk about the wide receivers of Notre Dame going up against the secondary of Michigan State. Michigan State has struggled in that area, but I've got my eye on Marcus Tye. He's going to do a tremendous job, number 11, the safety. He's going to have an opportunity to step up and make some big plays. They're going to need him. Catch those interceptions, because he's going to have a chance to catch some today.
We talked about this when we were there in the preseason, some young guys getting opportunities to step up in that secondary. It will be a challenge against Notre Dame. I mean, this is a team threw for 381 yards last week against Michigan, and we know how much that Michigan State secondary has struggled over the last couple of years. It is the Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report, and it continues here on the Big Ten Network.
Back in 1895, Lyman T. Davis cooked up the first batch of Wolf brand chili, and it's been a favorite of true Texans ever since. Matter of fact, we wonder if that very recipe helped make chili the state dish. Bold, feisty, fixed up with our authentic blend of seasonings, slow-cooked and simmered to perfection. It's enough to make any chili lover weak in the knees. Best part? The most popular chili in Texas is now coming to you. Wolf brand chili. Open up a big old can of Texas.
You know, most college students change their major before graduation. Not me. I always knew what I wanted to be.
And then I changed majors 8 or 9 times. It's a good thing Illinois has so many options. I wanted to find something to challenge me and stretch my abilities. I may not have succeeded at everything, but all those experiences helped me figure out what I was actually good at.
What are you, a comedian?
Explore Illinois. More choices. More chances to find your passion.
This week on Fox NFL Sunday, it all kicks off with the Ford Drive One Fox NFL Sunday pregame. Then, Dallas and Chicago collide as Tony Romo and the Cowboys take on the Bears. Or the Pete Carroll era begins as the Seahawks battle the Broncos. It's another delivery of great NFL action this week on Fox NFL Sunday.
He had the talent.
He just made plays that other people can't make.
He had the passion.
You want to establish yourself. You know, you want to go in there and compete.
And he had one goal that would not be denied.
I could not leave college without ever having played in the Rose Bowl.
The countdown of the Big Ten's greatest icons begins with number 20, Charles Woodson. Today, presented by Discover.
They thrived competing in the Big Ten and continued their success in the professional ranks every Thursday night. Find out how these former Big Ten stars arrived on the next level. This week, Mohsin Muhammad.
We had, you know, good years, we had bad years, but I think the thing it did was it built character. It taught you how to be resilient, taught you how to get knocked down and stand back up.
The Next Level, Thursday at 8 Eastern on the Big Ten Network.
Halftime in Champaign of Memorial Stadium. Wayne Larrabee along with former Michigan State standout Mohsin Mohammed, excellent first half as we saw. Very competitive first half. This is what we expected. We talked about the quarterbacks in the open of the program earlier today, and the quarterbacks have come to the fore. Let's start with Chandler Harnish.
Yeah, Chandler Harnish had 178 yards rushing last week, and no drop-off this week. He's off to another great start, and he's making big plays with his feet. He's been consistent in the pass game, but he's truly making a lot of plays running the football.
As we expected, out of 178 yards rushing the previous week in Northern Illinois' victory over North Dakota. And here's a 37-yard touchdown run by Harnish that got the Huskies going. All right. Nathan Shieldhouse. We knew he was slippery coming in. The Huskies aren't the first dogs that have trouble with him. I mean, let's go back to last week, Southern Illinois. The Salukis had trouble containing Nathan Shieldhouse.
Yeah, you know, and when he breaks contain right here, if you look, he can roll out of the pocket and make plays with his feet. Right here, he gets down the field, keeps his eyes up the field, and he's looking. He's got room on the sideline, and he can see the defensive back up the field. Now, the defensive back has his eyes on him, which allows him to jump up, throw the ball to Lattimore for a big play touchdown last week. Now, today, different story. He's jumping up over the top of the defense to make it plays with his feet and scoring touchdowns. Right there, he's shaking and baking, jumping up over defenders. He has the it factor, and I believe that you know, he'll continue to mature as a leader in this offense.
We've got some good running backs in this ball game here this afternoon, but right now the two quarterbacks lead each of their respective schools in rushing. Halftime in Champaign, Illinois comes from behind late to take the halftime lead, 18-12 over Northern.
Doc, I just got your email. I'm out for the season.
Don't worry about that. I switched to Sprint's $69.99 plan, so I get unlimited emails.
What does that mean?
It means I'm dropping you for my fantasy team, that's for sure.
What does that mean about my knee?
Oh, your knee's totally shattered. You see how hard that guy hit you?
I don't want to see it.
Hey, relax. Not costing me any extra.
Only Sprint gives you unlimited text, web, and calling to any mobile for just $69.99. Sprint, the Now Network.
Perfect. Hey. Wait, I'm John Lynch, 9-time Pro Bowler, world champ.
What do you bring to a party that has everything? Fresh, creamy Hass avocados. Nothing else will do.
Puppies!
He had the talent.
He just made plays that other people can't make.
He had the passion.
You want to establish yourself. You know, you want to go in there and compete.
And he had one goal that would not be denied.
I could not leave college without ever having played in the Rose Bowl.
The countdown to the Big Ten's greatest icons begins with number 20, Charles Woodson. Today, presented by Discover.
You're at the age where you don't get thrown by curveballs. This is the age of knowing how to get things done. So, why would you let something like erectile dysfunction get in your way? Isn't it time you talk to your doctor about Viagra? 20 million men already have. With every age comes responsibility. Ask your doctor if your heart is healthy enough for sex. Do not take Viagra if you take nitrates for chest pain, as it may cause an unsafe drop in blood pressure. Side effects may include headache, flushing, upset stomach, and abnormal vision. To avoid long-term injury, seek immediate medical help for an erection lasting more than 4 hours. Stop taking Viagra and call your doctor right away if you experience a sudden decrease or loss in vision or hearing. This is the age of taking action. Viagra. Talk to your doctor. See if America's most prescribed ED treatment is right for you.
Champion Apparel will be showcasing the history and traditions of the Big Ten. Today, we spotlight the Block I at Illinois. One of the nation's oldest student sections, the Block I can now be found in the end zone of Memorial Stadium. Comprised of 1,800 passionate Illini students, the Block I cheers, chants, and displays loyalty throughout the game, making Memorial Stadium a daunting place for anyone to play. The Block I, champion, it's how you play.
As we get set to start the third quarter, Illinois leads Northern Illinois 18-12. Good crowd on hand here today. Just under 51,000 here in Memorial Stadium. Big Ten football brought to you in high definition by Phillips Televisions. It's student sections in the north end zone here at Memorial Stadium. The statistics for this afternoon's first half. And there's a look at them. 5 hour energy. First half stats. Illinois on the ground getting it done. And the two quarterbacks, as I mentioned, have been prominent in those rushing attacks. And Northern's actually had the ball a little bit longer than Illinois. The Illini deferred their decision after they won the opening toss, and they will accept the football to begin the second half. Justin Green and Jack Ramsey will drop back deep. Former Illini Michael Klimovsky getting set to kick it away. Great to have you with us. It's overcast now, but just a beautiful afternoon for football in Champaign. Ramsey deep into the end zone, won't get a chance with this one. And Illinois will start the third quarter on offense, first and 10 from the Illini 20. Nathan Shieldhouse in that first half of play. Nine rushes, 78 yards, and a touchdown. Five of nine passing, 50 yards. He was sacked once.
The one stat that is definitely going to show up for this Illini football club if they don't get control of it is the penalties. They had six penalties for 60 yards in that first half.
Good point, Moose. And some of those penalties, a couple of them were 15 yarders. First and 10. That's LeShore, the lone back. The pitch, LeShore. Got a nice seal from Jeff Allen. And LeShore able to get to the outside, but not for much. Jake Kaufman played off the block on the defensive line and made the stop. He's the corporal of the United States Marine Corps. He had retired after last season, but still had a year of eligibility to go, and he was thinking about moving on in life, and he lives just across the street from the football stadium in DeKalb, and he got the itch again this spring and decided to come back this summer, and they were happy to have him, obviously. Spent two tours of duty in Iraq.
Absolutely, and I think he smelled the popcorn on Saturday morning. He heard the crowd roar, and he said, you know what, I'm ready to get back in this
yeah,
thing.
Yeah, and that was just the spring game.
Yeah.
Tracy Wilson shaken up, as you see, taken to the sidelines. He's the starting strong safety for Northern Illinois. Wilson replaced by Mike Sobel. Sobel coming back from an ACL injury suffered in the spring. Has made a miraculous comeback. Back in 3 months. Shieldhouse. Incomplete. Malines, Darius Malines, the true freshman out of Boynton Beach, Florida, the man he undershot. And it'll be a third down for Illinois.
Shieldhouse still has to mature a little bit as a pocket passer. He does a great job on the move, but he needs to mature a little bit when he stands in the pocket tall and delivers that football.
He's in the shotgun with the LeShore alongside. And IU had time to make its changes into the nickel defense. Illinois spreads the field. Four receivers. Shieldhouse. Overshot Faison, who had disengaged from the coverage of Mike Sobel. And it's fourth down, Illinois.
Yeah, he's going to kick himself for that when he goes back and watch the film, because he had Faison wide open on a corner pattern. And like I said, as he stands in that pocket, he has to feel confident that he can deliver balls and deliver strikes. And that time he came up a little bit long on that pass.
Santella averaged 52 yards on two punts in the first half. Kind of a line drive kick here. Tommy Davis makes the play on it. And he is down immediately by Aaron Gress. First and 10 for the Huskies, their first opportunity in the third quarter offensively when we come back.
Big Ten Network football is brought to you in part by Auto Owners Insurance. Get to know the independent agents representing Auto Owners Insurance, the no problem people. By Polaris. See the hardest working, smoothest riding off-road vehicle now at your local dealer. And by the Cooper Tire Take the Money and Ride national event.
There are a lot of ways to get past that 2:30 feel. Get another cup of coffee. A little cold water on the face. More coffee. Whatever that is. Or take one 5-hour energy. People choose 5-hour energy over 6 million times per week. It's quick, effective, and made to help hardworking people like you get past their 2:30.
We're happy about that.
Or 3:30. Or 4:30. 5-hour energy. Hours of energy now. No 2:30 feeling later.
Primetime on the Big Ten Network has gone big time. Every weeknight, up to 90 minutes of original shows. Big Time Dreams.
Everybody wants your autograph.
Big Time History.
And we've died, we come back.
Big Time Legends.
They will not catch you.
Saturday's game time, but primetime is big time. All this fall on the Big Ten Network.
This is for our albums coming out.
Listen, try one more.
What a diva.
I am. I'm singing.
Can I call you by your full name?
Kerosene.
Let me just work on a tear really quickly.
I'm so excited.
Why don't you laugh, Carrie? That was close, though, right?
Yeah, that was good.
Next Saturday, it's a huge slate of Big Ten football action. John Clay leads Wisconsin against Austin Peay. The Hawkeyes battle Ball State. Michigan State clashes with Northern Colorado. Or you'll see other great regional action.
Touchdown!
Next Saturday in HD, presented by the United States Marine Corps. Only on the Big Ten Network.
That youngster. I love rock and roll. How about that? Hey, if you're looking for another Big Ten Network game, go to BigTenNetwork.com/GameFinder to get the channel numbers for all of today's games. He was going to be tired after that dance routine. Dad. Dad was holding that youngster up there.
He was a healthy-looking boy, wasn't he?
First and 10 for Northern Illinois. Their first offensive possession of the second half. Blitz coming. Bellamy. Nobody there to pick him up. On a beta to the quarterback, and he hammers him down back at the 31-yard line.
Yeah, that time, you know, he got caught looking the other way. Harness is looking the other way, and as you can see, boom, coming in from the right side of your screen right there, Bellamy delivers the blow.
Moose, that's going to leave a mark tomorrow.
Yeah, that play was well timed out right there. He had no idea that that blitz was coming.
So it's a 9-yard loss, second down and 19. Chandler Harness, 8 of 12 passing in the first half of play. Operating out of the pistol, he's got Chad Spann behind him. The give to Spann up the middle. Bellamy quick to the ball again. Clay Nurse was also there. Relatively short gain, about 3 yards out to the 35, where it's third down and still long. Third and 16 coming up.
Two exceptional plays in a row for Trayvon Bellamy, the senior and leader of that defense. He goes about 6'205", but that time he came and collapsed down on that offensive line, sealing that gap up and making a good tackle on Chad Spann.
Trayvon moved from cornerback to strong safety 2 weeks before the first game of the season. They've had all kinds of problems in the offensive secondary for Illinois. Now it's third down and 7, make it 16. Chad Spann trying to get the end. He did for a moment, but not for long. Good pursuit made by Trulon Henry, another member of that somewhat maligned secondary of the Illini.
Chad Spann tries to get outside on the defense, but there's nowhere to go. There's no one home over there. I mean, there's nothing he can, not a shred of daylight there, and he'll have to wait till the next time they get the ball, see if he can get on track. And it's been a tough day for Chad Spann today.
Jack Ramsey back deep to receive this punt from Josh Wilbur. Kind of a line drive punt. Scud missile of a punt, but boy, this is not pretty, but it's effective. Down to the 11-yard line, just outside the 10. Now, they're not going to get much on style points there, but a very effective punt that time for Josh Wilbur, because the return man didn't make a play on a Jack Ramsey. Well, you know, we talked about Paul Petrino, the offensive coordinator of the Fighting Illini of Illinois,
He's got a green armband that he wears. You can see it maybe right there. And the letters FIST. And here's what they stand for. This is today's Verizon Key Connection. The FIST band worn by this team. Fundamentals, intensity, strength, and toughness. First and 10, Illinois back at its 10-yard line. 56-yard punt. LeShore, nice cutback, and again. First down out across the 20 to the 22-yard line. Sean Progar brought him down, 12-yard gain.
And I think, again, you see the ability for Mikael LeShore to get in the hole, be under control, find the daylight, make guys miss, and get up the field. And I think that goes to some of the attributes that Paul Petrino is trying to emphasize on this offense.
Northern defense huddled up across the way, or Northern offense huddled up across the way. Meanwhile, the Illinois offense on the attack, first and 10. LeShore, penalty marker down in the area of holding as LeShore gets it out to the 25.
I know Paul Petrino wasn't talking about that. I don't think that made the list on FIST there, but if you think
holding,
about
number 76, offense. 10-yard penalty will repeat first down.
Yeah, if you think about fundamentals, intensity, strength, and toughness, you know, this doesn't show up on, you know, one of these holding penalties, but the color, green, is staying in the green, and Paul Petrino talked a lot about staying on the positive side of run downs, and right now they're definitely 1-15, they're negative right now.
First and 20, yeah, they're not in the green zone now, at least not yet. This is Ford, gets it back to the 20-yard line. Where it'll be second down and 12. Alex Kubak made the tackle for Northern Illinois. Yeah, the penalties today against Illinois really at times stunted drives, Moose. You know, they've had a penalty or two in the red zone. They've had a penalty on a kick return, punt return that put Northern, instead of starting back in Husky territory, they start in the Illini zone. It's been one of those days that Illinois had to overcome a lot to get their 6-point lead. A lot of their own mistakes. Shieldhouse, and he's not going very far at all. Nabal Jefferson made the hit initially, and then he had some help from his friends.
That's going to put this team once again in a third and long situation. I think we analyze his play. You see that Nathan Shieldhouse, he's not really comfortable yet throwing the ball out of the pocket. He's got to be able to stand in there, see over his offensive line. That's a big offensive line. He's got to be able to stand in there and find his receiver and deliver a strike.
Illinois, 3 of 7 on third down conversions, facing, as you said, third and long. Third down of 14 yards to go. Football just short of the 19-yard line of Illinois. Shieldhouse gets it away to Faison. He has to make a play, but cannot. Good short tackle by Rashawn Melvin, who's really come on and played well. A former walk-on out of Waukegan, Illinois. Alan Baxter chased the quarterback, kind of flushed him a bit. It is fourth down.
That time, the NIU defense, led by their defensive coordinator, Clays, does a great job here of taking away the deep routes, putting pressure on the quarterback, and making him throw short.
Now, Tracy Clays does a great job with that defense for Northern Illinois. Santella, another punt. And a fair catch signal made. Tommy Davis secures the ball, 38-yard line, Husky territory. Third quarter, still the Illini by 6.
I'm the fourth string quarterback, but due to a pregame meal of all-you-can-eat calamari, now I'm the first string quarterback. But I'm also a transfer student, so I'm a little lost.
And if you've got cut rate insurance, your jacked up rates might make you sick. So get accident forgiveness from Allstate and be better protected from mayhem, like me.
Dollar for dollar, nobody protects you from mayhem like Allstate.
Today, Ben Chappell leads the explosive Indiana offense into a showdown with Western Kentucky.
Touchdown!
Today in HD, only on the Big Ten Network.
Finally, the show that gives you a voice is here.
The Big Ten Pulse, presented by Rotel and Velveeta.
If it's happening in the Big Ten Conference,
it's happening here on the Pulse.
Bold opinions.
What are you going to do now? There's no place to hide.
Strong debates.
Let him coach this team and let him decide what he's good and done.
And your chance to sound off. The Big Ten Pulse, presented by Rotel and Velveeta. Thursday night at 9 Eastern, only on the Big Ten Network.
Our goal was to bring something that is going to cure heart defects.
We try to give kids a little bit of direction, a little bit of mentoring. Once they get on their path, you know, they just kind of blossom on their own.
I love helping people, whether it's in Haiti or Africa or just here in Lafayette.
Give Big is a new initiative from the Big Ten Network, recognizing that being part of the Big Ten means giving back to our communities. Check out how Big Ten members are making a difference only on the Big Ten Network.
They thrived competing in the Big Ten and continued their success in the professional ranks every Thursday night. Find out how these former Big Ten stars arrived on the next level. This week, Mohsin Mohammed.
We had, you know, good years, we had bad years, but I think the thing it did was it built character. It taught you how to be resilient, taught you how to get knocked down and stand back up.
The Next Level, Thursday at 8 Eastern on the Big Ten Network.
The State Farm Wrap-Up, immediately after the game, only on the Big Ten Network.
Today's Sprint Epic Run features NIU's upset win over Purdue last season, almost a year to the date. September 19, 2009, a 28-21 victory by the Huskies. They scored 21 unanswered points in the second quarter with a total domination of time of possession. 41 minutes, 40 seconds to 18-20, and total yards, 454 to 335. First Big Ten win for the Huskies in 21 seasons. Let me take a look. Since Joe Novak took over that program up there in DeKalb and got things turned around 3 years into his regime, NIU has more than held its own.
You got to feel good about their position right now in this game as well.
Harnish faked the end around, and the Illini were having none of it. Read beautifully by Merciless and Legit on the interior of the defensive front for Illinois. Coach Kill, as we mentioned, was being treated for some issues due to surgery a couple of weeks ago. Spent the week in the hospital in Chicago. Back for the game here today. Doesn't look like a guy who spent a week at a hospital, does he?
Oh, absolutely.
He's been up and down those sidelines.
He's pacing like a caged animal over there.
It's good to see him. He's done a tremendous job with that program. Second and 10. That's Nathan Palmer, the man in motion. And the tight end not going far at all. Beautiful tackle made by Martez Wilson on Jack Marks. Gain of two, third and eight.
All right, let's freeze the screen right there. We got right here is my man Martez. And he's got his eye in that backfield, and now he's going to pursue to the tight end Jack Marks. Makes the tackle. Nice job for the big fella.
Is that what you call reading the eyes of the quarterback?
Read the eyes of the quarterback and make plays. Rely on your instincts and let your natural ability take over.
Third and eight for the Huskies from their 40. Kreider in the backfield with Harnish. Harnish under pressure. Corey Legit.
Harnish is sacked by
the Illini defense makes a stand. Second sack of this second half.
I think they know Harnish wants to run the ball now. You know, he's going to look up the field, and if nothing is there, he's going to take off. And it's important for that defensive line not to over-pursue, keep contained.
Out in punt formation, Wilbur for Northern Illinois. Ramsey back deep for Illinois. Oh, he brought rain with this one. Ramsey over the shoulder catch. Steps out of bounds in the vicinity of the 11-yard line. What a punt by Josh Wilbur.
Looks like a cramp. I think Ramsey caught a cramp of some sort as he went back to catch that punt. And he's beautiful catch over the shoulder. Looks like a wide receiver. You know, he went from defensive back to wide receiver. And
yeah, there it is.
He cramped up. Otherwise, I don't think he steps out of bounds there. But I think he may have caught a cramp in that calf muscle.
That appears to be the case. He's coming to the near sidelines. Football fans, you can create your own football highlight reels each week with the Big Ten football mashup presented by Buffalo Wild Wings. Go to mashup.bigtennetwork.com right now to compile your favorite plays and share them with your friends. Illinois will start again deep in their own territory, Moose. First and 10 at the 11-yard line. This certainly affects what you can call offensively, doesn't it? Usually have major impact. Field position. They get motion from the tight end, Evan Wilson. He's a good one. LeShore behind that motion. Malines held his block on the flank of that play at wide receiver. And LeShore has got a first down to the 26-yard line of Illinois. On a 15-yard gain.
That play was started by number 89, Evan Wilson, that went in motion and sealed the line of scrimmage. And has an... Now Mikael Shore has an opportunity to get up the field and get behind the great block of Darius Milenis.
First and 10 football just across the 26-yard line of Illinois. The Illini lead by six. We're under 7 minutes to go in this third quarter. LeShore in the tail of the tandem in what they call the shot. It's more like a pistol offense. There's the pitch, LeShore into the open field. One-on-one, and a beautiful play made by Rashawn Melvin once again. Redshirt sophomore out of Waukegan. I'll tell you what, he's played tough against the run for a cornerback.
Yeah, he's had to look at some big 230-pound running backs today, and on this particular play, he comes up and makes an outstanding tackle. Notice where he's attacking those big running backs from the knees down. He's just grabbing those legs and wrapping them up and assuring the tackle.
Jason Ford in the backfield, second down. Shieldhouse still has it. And the linebacker in the middle of that defense, Devon Butler, made the hit.
Paul Petrino is doing a good job of mixing up running plays here, getting them in third down in manageable situations. In the first down, they had a couple of third and long situations and could not convert. These situations, a lot easier.
LeShore, who's in the offensive backfield, has gone over 100 yards each of the first three games of the season. 100 yards rushing, third down and short. Why not LeShore? And he nearly escaped. Got the first down nonetheless, and Butler again makes the tackle in the middle of the defense for the Huskies.
Butler was holding on it for dear life right
what?
There.
Goodness.
LeShore does a great job of dragging him for the first down.
Injured Illini down in the field.
3-yard run for LeShore.
One of the linemen is down. Hugh Thornton's down. Started the final seven games of last year as a true freshman. He's a sophomore. You play that much that early in your career, and they're pretty high on you. So we've got a timeout. 5:41 left to go here in the third. Illinois on top.
Watch Big Ten games at home or watch them on the go with Verizon. Live college games, including Big Ten Network broadcasts, streaming right to your VCast phone. Only from Verizon.
Mobile and watch live Thursday and Sunday night NFL games and NFL Red Zone. Now everything football is everywhere. Only with Verizon. Rule the air.
You don't really think about stability until you don't have it. Auto Owners Insurance has been safe, sound, and secure for over 90 years. That's stability you can count on. Contact your independent Auto Owners Insurance agent today. Ranked highest in customer satisfaction with the Auto Insurance Claims Experience 2 years in a row by J.D. Power & Associates. Auto Owners Insurance. The no problem people.
New shoes?
You're watching the Big Ten Network.
This fall, don't just get more out of your tires, get more back from your tires. Because with Cooper's Take the Money and Ride National event, you'll not only get unbeatable performance, you'll get a rebate card by mail when you buy four qualifying Cooper tires. Cooper's Take the Money and Ride National event. Get your rebate form and all the terms and conditions at a participating Cooper Tire dealer or at CooperTireRebates.com. Cooper Tires, don't give up a thing.
embarrassing to say, delicious to eat. It's the Super Rooty Tooty Fresh and Fruity starting at $4.99. It's value covered with fruit and whipped topping. IHOP. Come hungry, leave happy.
Well, Hugh Thornton, the sophomore out of Oberlin, Ohio, is still down on the field. They were able to roll him over, but they were really taking care of his neck. And let's take a look at that play once again. Number 72, right side of your screen.
72 right here. If you look at 72, he's going to pull and make contact with Jake Kaufman. Low man typically wins, but you need to see what you hit. And as he goes down to make that cut block, Kaufman meets him, and I think he hits him right on the back of the neck, and that's a serious place to get hit there. And they're using every precaution as they take him off the field.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's something that was a point of emphasis, you know, hits like that, Moose. And of course, what they were talking about a lot with the officials this year is open field hits where a defender might lower his helmet into a receiver, that type of thing. But also, it can happen anywhere on the field. And you know, your point is well taken. Coaches often say, see what you hit, because that keeps your head up. But the other factor is this. Remember, we talked about earlier today, low man wins in this game. And you're a big offensive lineman. You're trying to get under that defensive end. And that's all that Hugh was trying to do when his helmet came down and they collided. And hopefully it's, you know, they're taking precautions here, but hopefully he'll be okay.
Yeah, when you have running backs like Mikael LeShore, Jason Ford, and even Nathan Shieldhouse that runs the ball, typically big linemen, they try to get out of the way of those runners. And so what they'll often do is they'll throw. They'll throw at the legs of the defender, or they'll try to cut block, or, you know, just try to keep their feet moving to get out of the way. And it looked like that's what he was attempting to do. And, you know, Jake Kaufman met him in the hole. They both were trying to go low.
When he was down on his stomach and when they rolled him over during our commercial break, and a nice round of applause from the crowd here at Memorial Stadium, you could tell they were holding his helmet and his neck in place just to make sure. And now they've got him on the stretcher, and they'll bring him in for x-rays. But it
very serious location where he was.
Yeah.
Where the contact took place, right on the back of the neck. And, you know, there's a lot of nerves and a lot of things that, you know, could be serious if damaged in that area. So,
and we hope that that's not the case. And again, they take precautions. Hyo is still down on the field. They were able to roll him over, but they were really taking care of his neck. And yeah, let's take a look at that play once again. Number 72, right side of your screen.
72, right. If you look at 72, he's going to pull and make contact with Jake Kaufman. Low man typically wins, but you need to see what you hit. And as he goes down to make that cut block, Kaufman meets him, and I think he hits him right on the back of the neck, and that's a serious place to get hit there. And they're using every precaution as they take him off the field.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's something that was a point of emphasis, you know, hits like that, Moose. And of course, what they were talking about a lot with the officials this year is open field hits where a defender might lower his helmet into a receiver, that type of thing. But also, it can happen anywhere on the field. And you know, your point is well taken. The coaches often say, see what you hit, because that keeps your head up. But the other factor is this. Remember, we talked about earlier today, low man wins in this game. And you're a big offensive lineman. You're trying to get under that defensive end. And that's all that Hugh was trying to do when his helmet came down and they collided. And hopefully it's, you know, they're taking precautions here, but hopefully he'll be okay.
Yeah, when we have running backs like Mikael LeShore, Jason Ford, and even Nathan Shieldhouse that runs the ball, typically big linemen, they try to get out of the way of those runners. And so what they'll often do is they'll throw at the legs of the defender, or they'll try to cut block, or, you know, just try to keep their feet moving to get out of the way. And and it looked like that's what he was attempting to do. And, you know, Jake Kaufman met him in the hole. They both were trying to go low.
When he was down on his stomach and when they rolled him over during our commercial break, and a nice round of applause from the crowd here at Memorial Stadium, you could tell they were holding his helmet and his neck in place just to make sure. And now they've got him on the stretcher, and they'll bring him in for x-rays. But it
very serious location where he was.
Yeah.
Where the contact took place, right on the back of the neck. And, you know, there's a lot of nerves and a lot of things that, you know, could be serious if damaged right in that area. So,
and we hope that that's not the case. And again, they take precautions like this, and certainly for good reason. But here's when they rolled him over a few minutes ago. He was on his stomach for now. They roll him over. You see how the trainer has held his neck and his helmet in place. Then they were able to get him under the stretcher, and they'll have him heading back to the locker room, and they'll do some x-rays. But every precaution taken, whether they feel like there's a serious injury or not, you take precautions in this case. And the Illinois staff here did an outstanding job of getting to the player and taking care of him. And we hope that that it's not a long-term injury problem whatsoever.
Yeah. You know, our thoughts and prayers will go out to Hugh right now and everyone there that is involved with that. And you can tell that they really took precautions, like you said, Wayne, when they rolled him over, securing his head. And then when they got him strapped to the board, they secured his head once again. And then getting him off to the field and making sure that, that he's okay. I mean, this is a very important deal.
You see concern. Now, that's Northern Illinois on the far side, and of course the Illini on the near side, but both sides, this has been a stoppage in action. All the energy and everything else, you know, for a moment is out of the crowd in the stadium. Players concerned on both sides. Your player, not long ago, very recently, you've seen situations like this. What goes through your mind?
Yeah, I mean, you have general concern for any player that's on the field, and we often, you know, played against guys who you might have played with in college, or, you know, see guys before the game, and your good friends, see guys in the offseason. So
in this case, you may have played high school football with or against someone on the other team.
Absolutely. You know, I mean, these guys know each other. They're from the same state here. A lot of these guys are, you know, maybe from some of the same hometowns. And so, you know, they have a general concern. I mean, you're out here competing and playing the game at a very high level. But, you know, you don't want to see anyone get hurt or have a serious injury.
You mentioned to me last night that one of the things about being a player on this level, high school level, being pro level, you use the word fraternity. And,
yes,
and although you guys will go out and try to knock each other's block off on Saturday afternoon, nonetheless, in the long run, you're all part of the same fraternity.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And, you know, these guys, like you say, they may one day be teammates in on the other level and in the professional ranks, you know. And right now, you know, there's just a general concern for each other, and you know, that's important. I mean, we're like a fraternity.
Sure,
we're like a fraternity.
Absolutely.
Definitely.
And so, you know, we wish Hugh Thornton all the best, and And the other factor that is a fact of life in football, somebody goes down. Mm-hmm. If it's in practice, they just move to the other side of the field. If it's in a game, they take care of the injured player, and the game goes on.
The game does the game does go on, and so, you know, they'll make sure that, you know, Hugh Thornton is well taken care of, and now there'll be another player that steps up and has an opportunity to fill his shoes. Now, that's a good sign.
That's a very good sign.
That's a very good sign. You know, he may have lost a little bit of feeling, but you can tell he is having some feeling in his lower extremities and some feeling in his arms. So, you know, that is a very, very positive sign.
And that's not just for the crowd. That's for his teammates and his opponent as well. They let everybody know that, hey, listen.
Family back home watching.
Yep. Absolutely.
You know, mom is somewhere watching this game. Dad may be somewhere watching this game. Any family, you know, friends, hey, I'm okay. And that's what he wants you to know. I'll be okay.
So the Illini up to the line of scrimmage, first and 10. First and 10 at the Illinois 39-yard line. Shielhouse at quarterback. LeShore the tailback, and it is Mikel LeShore. Running off that left side of the line, gets out to the 40-yard line. Alex Kuba makes the tackle.
Good, honest, hard-working run down there. You're not going to get a big play on every single run down, but you got to force it in there, keep the defense honest, test their weaknesses. It's a good play.
They moved Randall Hunt to that tackle position. And Jack Cornell comes into the offensive line in place of the injured Hugh Thornton, and not much there for Shielhouse. It'll be third down coming up for Illinois. Illinois flips their offensive linemen, strong side to weak side, meaning the tight end side of the line. And so Jack Cornell, who's a tackle, has come into the guard spot in place of the injured Hugh Thornton. Now it's third down. And a timeout taken by Northern Illinois. So third down and almost 4 yards to go coming up for Illinois. And we've got a timeout on the field. 4:17 left to go here in the third quarter, along with the former Michigan State standout wide receiver, Mohsin Mohammed. I'm Wayne Larrivee. Great to have you with us. Before we go any further here, let's head back to Dave Revson in the studio for a Discover Game Break.
Thank you, Wayne. 28 straight points now for Michigan against UMass. They are trailing at 17-7. They lead it now 35-17. Denard Robinson with the touchdown run. So Wolverines up 18 as they play in the third.
Thanks very much, Dave. Now for the Rotel and Velveeta combination of the game, because you can't win without the perfect partner.
Kool-Aid wasn't that sweet in the first half for University of Michigan, but that maize and blue color Kool-Aid is picking up a little flavor now.
Yes, it is. And you have a little Velveeta with that Kool-Aid you're talking about. And here's the combination of the game. Shielhouse and LeShore. What a job they've done. LeShore over 100 yards rushing for the third straight game this season. If I'm not mistaken, I think that's six games in a row dating back to last year.
He's the true workhorse of that offense.
Third down for Illinois. Third and about four. Later going third quarter, and they go to LeShore, and he's not going to get it. Well, they've seen that so many times. Perkle came in there to, I beg your pardon, Progar on the tackle, along with Clark in the linebacking core, and Butler helped to clog it up. It is fourth down, so a good stand there for the Northern Illinois defense.
Out of that formation, they've had three or four big plays where Shielhouse kept the ball. That time, you know, he gave the ball to Mikael LeShore, and he probably wish he would have kept it.
Tommy Davis back deep, and Santella hangs it high. Davis lets it go. Hits on the 7-yard line and caroms sideways out of bounds just across the 10. Well done. Well done by Anthony Santella, the senior punter out of Wakanda, Illinois.
Out of bounds at the 12-yard line.
Tomorrow on Fox NFL Sunday, the Bears look to stay undefeated as they head to Dallas to take on Tony Romo and the Cowboys. Cowboys trying to recover from a tough week one loss in Washington. Coverage begins tomorrow, noon Eastern, with the Fox NFL pregame show. Check local listings for the game in your area.
controversial win for the Bears as well.
Yes, it was. Process of a catch, Moose. It's a process now. This is a keeper. Planned play. And not much for Chandler Hardish.
Chandler Hardish, the ball carrier.
You're right.
Thomas was there.
There is a process of a catch, isn't it? We were talking about that before the game started, that, you know, you have to hold on to that ball throughout the whole process of the play if you hit the ground and whatnot.
Absolutely. And the rule that people are talking about in Chicago is very much the same type of rule the way they have on this level on the collegiate game.
Yeah.
It's again, you've got to secure the football and keep it secure until the official blows the whistle. Receivers. Couple of them to the top of your screen. One to the bottom. Harnish rolling to the top. Nice throw on the move. And he's got a first down to Landon Cox, just short of the 25-yard line. Justin Green responding from the secondary. Julon Henry was also there.
It's a good job of Chandler Harnish getting out of the pocket, running left. Getting the ball to Cox. They said they had an emphasis on getting him the ball this week. And they're proving that true.
Illinois leading it by six as we head toward the fourth quarter. A little over 2.5 minutes to go here in the third. Span is the tailback. Scarb, the fullback, in motion. Harnish, a long throw and a good route and catch made by Landon Cox once again. This went out near the 34-yard line, just short of the first down, 9-yard gain.
Very dangerous throw right there. It has to come over the head of a defensive back, but Chandler Harnish does a great job with the touch of completing that pass. And I tell you what, Landon Cox is off to a good game here.
You're right. Harnish had to thread the needle there, no doubt about it. Second down and short. Span. Second effort got him the first down to the 35-yard line. I had it well stacked up inside to the Fighting Illini of Illinois.
Stingy defense. I know I keep saying that over and over and over again, but they are keen on Chad Span. They're not going to let him beat them.
Hazy sunshine here at Memorial Stadium now. And things just starting to heat up on the field. First and 10. Final 2 minutes, third quarter. Span. Well, I tell you what. Having none of it was Justin Staples along that defensive front, a sophomore out of Lakewood, Ohio.
Talked to Justin Staples before the game, and boy, was he ready. He had his headphones on. He's walking around, and he said, man, I'm ready to play. I'm going all out today. I'm ready to hit the field and give it my best. So.
Justin playing with a heavy heart. His dad passed away a few weeks ago. The coaching staff very impressed with this young man, the hard work he's put in. Second down and about nine. Play action over the middle on the crossing pattern. Martell Moore, pretty well played by Trayvon Bellamy, who makes the tackle of the 40, 4-yard gain.
Yeah, and here we go with that crossing route once again by Martell Moore. Got his hand up in the air. Hey, mailbox, give me the ball. He gets it. Trayvon Bellamy's here to stop him, though. Good all-around play by both sides here. Good execution.
Third down for Northern Illinois. Harnish now 12 of 16 passing. Over the middle, got his man. Once again, the crossing pattern. And this time, Martell Moore turns it upfield into Illinois territory to the 46-yard line where Justin Green makes the hit.
This time, they catch him in a zone. Before it was man, they had Trayvon Bellamy there to make the play. But guess what? If you run zone, there's going to be cavities in that defense. And so now Martell Moore gets an opportunity to catch the ball and get up the field.
And Moose, where the cavity seems to be more is underneath the coverage, underneath the second line of coverage, right?
Absolutely. Well, when you have a couple of wide receivers on that side that are stretching the defense, they're pushing guys back. And then what you do is you leak out a wide receiver underneath that cavity of the defense.
Time to swap sides. Third quarter comes to a close here in Champaign. Illinois hanging on to a 6-point margin, the same score we had at halftime.
This is great.
Thank you.
Big Ten football and beyond, presented by Sonic, Wednesday, only on the Big Ten Network.
And they're off and running. Now let's take a look at our Chex Mix fan can. Chex Mix on game day. We're made to mix. Gotta love the energy in that north end zone here at Memorial Stadium. First play of the fourth quarter, first down. Harness fumbles, recovered by Illinois. The Illini get the first turnover of the game. The recovery by Tavon Wilson.
Let's take a look at this. Harness trying to secure the ball. Oh, great job of getting the elbow, get something on the ball. He pops it loose. Harness can't keep on. Illinois recover. That's a huge play at this part of the game.
Fumble forced by Ian Thomas. One of the coaches raving about the way he's been playing this season. He makes the biggest play to date of this game. Northern Illinois was about to crank it up there. Now the Illini get their big play defensively. Can Shieldhouse capitalize? Butler pursues and chases down the elusive quarterback from Illinois near the 32-yard line, gain of two. Back to Dave Rudson of the studio. Discover Game Break, Dave.
Wayne, thanks. Checking in on Purdue and Ball State. Another intrastate battle. Rob Henry in for the banged up Robert Marv. And this just how they drew it up off the deflection. Cortez Smith, 76 yards. Boilers get some breathing room. It's 21-6.
Thank you, Dave. Ball State will be at Iowa next week. Second down. This is LeSure. Not much doing there. I mentioned biggest play. You got the feeling on that scamper by Harness that Northern Illinois was about to grasp momentum in this ball game, down by just six. Well, that forced fumble and then the subsequent recovery, that turned the table completely. You get the feeling now that the air might have been taken out of the sails of the Huskies. Not that it's over by any stretch, but that was a huge play in this game.
Yeah, that was a huge play. And, you know, they're down by 6 points. You start the fourth quarter. You have a big play, have an opportunity to get in scoring position, and you turn the ball over. That's a little deflating.
Illinois has not intercepted a pass in two-plus games yet, but they've forced a couple of big fumbles, including one last week that helped stave off a comeback by the Salukis.
Yeah, and I tell you what, if Tyrone Clark has his head up on that play,
he had an interception.
He had a pick six almost, right? Yeah. He could have, you know, no one was back to tackle him. Let's take a look at that. I mean, you know, as you look at Shieldhouse's eyes coming across the screen, look at, well,
he
did not see it. A.J. Jenkins coming across the field. He was not going to put, he had the gator arms there a little bit, you know. And Tyrone Clark, he had an opportunity there to make a big play.
Here's the punt by Santella. Davis back to you. Boy, he just booms this one. And into the end zone. Northern will take over at the 20-yard line.
Kind of like this number 87.
I'll tell you what, he's got some pop in that leg. He's stroking that driver 300 yards down the middle.
That's right.
Starting today, the Big Ten Network unveils a new series that counts down the top athletes in the conference's rich history. Today we unveil number 20, former Michigan great and Heisman winner Charles Woodson. Big Ten Icons, hosted by Keith Jackson, premieres today, 4 Eastern only on the Big Ten Network. Now I want you to watch this show, folks, because you won't believe what Lloyd Carr did to get Charles Woodson to play against Ohio State his sophomore year.
Is that what you call a teaser?
You're learning fast, my friend. First and 10, Chad Spann, the tailback and the pistol. Harness with that shoulder fake. Got his man wide open. That's Marks, the tight end. Boy, he's really been trying to go to him and has thrown, targeted that receiver on numerous occasions. This one, 22 yards and a first down for Jerry Kill's Huskies.
Yeah, you know, this time here, our tight end is going to leak out here. I think this, this tight end over here is going to leak out. And he's going to come across, and we can roll that footage. He's going to leak out across, and the run that brings up the defender and allows him to be wide open in the cavity of that defense.
First and 10. Harnish.
Oh.
And what are they going to roll here? Incomplete. Out of bounds.
And there goes that rule we talked about. You got to be in bounds on any possession, catch or interception. Both feet have to be in bounds in order for that to be a completed a completed catch on either
watch
side.
Watch this again. Justin Green all over it, and he denies Palmer, and they tie it up. And out of bounds before possession established. Simultaneous possession. That goes as an incompletion. Second and 10. And they may be asking for a review.
They definitely going to replay that because there was...
The play is under further review.
Yeah, there was a catch made there by the wide receiver, and simultaneously the defensive back. Now, a tie typically goes to the wide receiver. I don't know if it's going to be merited in this case because Green was all over that, and it looked like he had possession of the football first.
Let's take another look at it.
He jumps right in front and makes this catch.
Who makes the catch? Does Green or Palmer? Palmer, the wide receiver, and does Green have possession? And does he have possession before he hits out of bounds? Even if it is an interception by Green, does he have that ball secured before his foot hits out of bounds? And they're looking at all of those factors.
Yeah, you know, I think it's going to be important, and that's why we have the replay to determine if he had possession prior to his, I think it was his right foot that stepped out of bounds. So at what point did he have possession? That's going to be a key factor here. And then also, are they going to determine if the wide receiver also was making a catch there the same time that Green was grasping that football?
Depending on what colored sunglasses you're looking at that play, be it Husky black or Illini orange,
right.
You know, you could say, well, yeah, Nathan Palmer was making a catch, or that Green made the interception. Justin Green, here's the call.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands, incomplete pass.
And Moose, what that means is that the replay officials did not have enough video evidence to change the call on the field. So it goes as an incomplete pass. Another look at it.
And if they ruled it an incomplete pass, that means that neither player had possession prior to one of them stepping out of bounds, and Green was the one that stepped out of bounds.
As I said, they did not have indisputable video evidence to overturn that play.
Absolutely.
So the play stands. Now Chad Spann, the tailback, alongside Harnish, who gets a reprieve here on second down and 10. Harnish being flushed. Penalty marker down in the backfield, maybe for a hold. Tackle completed by Justin Staples.
I think Evan Frierson is the defender that was held on that play. Evan Frierson usually comes in and gives a little bit of relief to that.
Holding number 28, offense. 10-yard penalty, repeat, second down.
Yeah, he comes in and he gives a little bit of relief for that linebacking core. He's on the end of the line of scrimmage. You can see him right in the middle of your screen.
See, oh, he had a shirt.
Getting pulled a little bit right there. Yeah, you're going to see that.
There he is.
Yep, right there. There he goes. That Chad Spann.
Chad Spann is trying to hold off that on rushing Illini.
Yep.
Only the second penalty against Northern Illinois, but it backs him up now. Second down. Second and 20.
Penalties will kill the drive.
Harnish has been efficient in the air. One figures he'll have to hit a few more crossing patterns to get a first down here. Hopkins in the offensive backfield. Time winding down to the play clock, and did Northern Illinois get a timeout called here? No, there's a flag down. It should be for delay of game. Remember, Northern Illinois has already taken a timeout in this second half.
Well, prior to the penalty, it just seemed like they hadn't been offense. They hadn't reset the clock there.
Second down.
I think that's why Coach Kill was out on the field. Maybe that was his point. Did they reset the clock?
Did they reset the
clock? Play clock we're talking about.
Yeah, from the time they announced the penalty, it didn't seem like they had enough time to even get out of the huddle and snap a play.
Well, it's second down and long. Second and 25. Football now back at the 27-yard line of Northern Illinois. Harnish, under pressure, gets it away nicely. Change of direction by Hopkins, but he's going nowhere. Ian Thomas with good pursuit. Also in on that tackle, Martez Wilson. Clay Nurse, though, is the man who turned that play around on the outside.
With the speed of this linebacking core, you need to go north and south as a ball carrier. These linebackers are way too fast. Nate Bussey, Martez Wilson and the leading tackler from last year, Ian Thomas, they're going to pursue. They can go east and west, and they can get to the football. You got to go north and south as a ball carrier.
Jazz Hopkins loses four. Third down and a mile. Third and 29 if you're keeping track. Palmer in motion. Hopkins has running room, but again, instead of taking it straight ahead, he's going to the east, and down he goes. Justin Staples tracked him down. Steve Hall was also there. We get word from the Illini sidelines on Hugh Thornton, the injured offensive guard, taken to the hospital for further evaluation. He has movement in all extremities, so that certainly is good news.
That's promising. That's promising. Hate to see injuries like that in this game.
Illinois extends the drive of the Huskies, gets them off the field thanks to a couple of penalties. Bearcat signal made on this punt by Faison, and he's got it. Back inside the 30, near the Illini, 27-yard line. Timeout, fourth quarter, Illinois hanging on by six. Big Ten Network football is presented by the United States Marine Corps, the few, the proud, the Marines. By Phillips Televisions, so amazing you won't be able to take your eyes off of it. Rotel and Velveeta, try Rotel and Velveeta's famous queso dip, the ultimate game day snack. And by Verizon, own the airwaves. The signal is yours. Verizon, rule the air.
There are those who dedicate themselves to a sense of honor, to a life of courage, and a commitment to something greater than themselves. They have always defended this nation and each other. They still do. The few. The proud. The Marines.
Thank you for calling USA Prime Credit. My name is Peggy.
What is problem, please?
Peggy? Sure. Well, suddenly it looks like I'm being charged
a $35 annual fee.
Yes?
Tell me it's a mistake.
Yes?
Are you saying yes? Are you asking yes?
Yes.
Peggy?
Want better customer service? Switch to Discover. Rank number one in customer loyalty. It pays to Discover.
The key to a great football party is Hass Avocados. Tell us your favorite Hass Avocado recipe, and you could win a trip for four to the Rose Bowl game. Enter today at avocadokickoff.com.
Down by seven. Final play for Detroit.
Only thing that would make this any better is overtime.
They'll need a miracle to win this football game. Harris slot right, drops back. Hines takes the pass at the 30. In the seam! Wow! Can you believe it? One man to beat! We're headed to overtime!
Buffalo Wild Wings, you have to be here.
Field goal for the win!
State Farm agent Carrie Maddox
loves to tell everyone how drivers can get discounts up to 40%. Your neighbors can tell you, too. There are probably some of State Farm's 40 million drivers, so talk to them. Then call a State Farm agent like me.
Call her.
Next Saturday, it's another slate of great Big Ten action presented by the United States Marine Corps. Check local listings for the game in your area or go to BigTenNetwork.com/GameFinder to find your school's game. Illinois leading by six. We have 10:26 to go in this fourth quarter. And the Illini take over, first and 10 at their 27-yard line. Shieldhouse and LeSure in the backfield. This is LeSure up the middle, big hole. Tommy Davis able to get him down out across the 35 or the 38-yard line. First and 10, gain of a quick 11 yards.
It's that big play once again. Paul Petrino keeps dialing that same play up, and you're going to see Nathan Shieldhouse either keep that or hand that ball off to Mikael LeSure, and he has the option to do either.
LeSure has topped 100 yards rushing in each game this season. He's a Doak Walker Award candidate. First and 10, football just short of the 39-yard line of Illinois. Shieldhouse still has it. to the midfield marker into Northern Territory and taken down out of bounds by Rashawn Melvin. Right in front of the Northern bench. First down to the 48-yard line of the Huskies for the Fighting Illini of Illinois. 12-yard gain.
I think Shieldhouse goes over 100 yards with that carry right there. throw the ball. He wants to see him throwing the ball. I don't blame him now. I mean, you know, either quarterback or running back. I think, you know, he's both, though. But he wants to see him get those stats up throwing the football.
97 yards rushing on 14 carries. First and 10. Sure. Oh, nice patient run. And now the acceleration. He's got another gear. Inside the 25-yard line to the Husky 24.
Outraces Tommy Davis right there. Gets through the hole. And I'll tell you what, he does a great job of patience right here. As he gets the handoff, he's waiting for his blocker to seal that edge right there. I believe that's Posick. He seals the edge for him and allows him to get up the field for a big gainer.
24 big yards. Illinois on the drive now, the 24-yard line. Jason Ford spells LeShore in the backfield. Don't forget about Jenkins at the bottom of your screen. It's time to run the football. Ford is stacked up. That play was blown up by Mike Krause, the defensive tackle inside. Stacked it up, loss of 1 second and 11.
They're not going to let Jason Ford get loose in this game. They know when he comes in, he's the bruising back, and typically they're going to give it to him between the teeth of the defense.
Nearing 8 minutes to go. Ford, the lone setback, and he gets it. Had a nice hole, and then Butler, the middle linebacker, was waiting for him. As he got past the defensive line and brings him down to the 21-yard line, gain of 5. Now, Illinois, just 4 of 11 on third downs. Jerry Kill's defense done a pretty good job in that regard, but Brian Zook's offense wants to run the clock, continue to run the clock, and if they are to continue this drive, face third down and 7.
Paul Petrino is just making good decisions right here and allowing his quarterback to control the football game.
And watch the play clock, Moose. This is where the quarterback tries to get that play clock well under 10 seconds. Got the snap off. About 6 seconds to go on the play clock. Shieldhouse close to the first down. Went down to the 15-yard line.
Now, if they elect to go for it, you know, they could do that. But it kick a field goal right here, and it's a two-possession game. Now, Shieldhouse has got to be careful with that football. He's hanging it out there like a loaf of bread. And I know he's trying to fake out a defender and create a little bit more running room, but that could lead to trouble.
And there's 7.5 minutes to go. This will be a 32-yard field goal attempt for Derek Dimke. Out of the hole to the punter, Anthony Santella. Dimke right down the boulevard. It is good. Illinois now leading 21-12 with 7:07 to go in the fourth quarter. The junior from Rockford, Illinois rings true.
Philips HD TV. You can't take your eyes off of it.
When the game is over, stick around for the State Farm Wrap-Up. In-depth highlights from the entire conference and complete analysis from our college football experts. The State Farm Wrap-Up, immediately after the game, only on the Big Ten Network.
Primetime on the Big Ten Network has gone big time. Every weeknight, up to 90 minutes of original shows. Big Time Dreams.
Everybody wants your autograph.
Big Time History.
And we've done, we've come back.
Big Time Legends. Saturday's game time, but prime time is big time. All this fall on the Big Ten Network.
This is for our albums coming out.
Let's try one more.
What a diva.
I am. I'm singing.
full name?
Kerosene.
Let me just work on a tear really quickly.
I'm so excited.
Why don't you laugh, Carrie?
That was close, though, right?
I'm good, I'm good.
Our goal was to bring something that is going to cure heart defects.
We try to give kids a little bit of direction, a little bit of mentoring. Once they get on their path, you know, they just kind of blossom on their own.
I love helping people, whether it's in Haiti or Africa or just here in Lafayette.
Give Big is a new initiative from the Big Ten Network, recognizing that being part of the Big Ten means giving back to our communities. Check out how Big Ten members are making a difference only on the Big Ten Network.
The State Farm Wrap-Up, immediately after the game, only on the Big Ten Network.
The Polaris, hardest working player today, well, Martez Wilson. You see the original superstar, the original hard working player, Rhett Grange, here to the line. Martez Wilson, who they've been hoping will really come into form. Well, today, very busy, 10 total tackles, 1.5 tackles behind the line of scrimmage, and a half sack today for Martez Wilson, who's coming off an injury last year, a neck injury that cost him 11 games in his season.
I know he doesn't want to share that half a sack, I'll tell you that much. He wants a whole one all to himself.
And there's Dimke's kick through the end zone. Dimke just added a field goal to push Illinois into a 21-12 9-point lead. 2 for 2 today, 9 for 9 in the field goal department in his career. And as we mentioned, he had a 52-yarder in the opener against Missouri. Well, work cut out for Chandler Harnish and company. They have 7:07 with which to work. 2 timeouts left for the Huskies. And here they are to the line of scrimmage. Northern Illinois, one of the favorites, one of the preseason favorites in the Western Division of the MAC. Came in here 1-1 off a loss at Iowa State and a win at home over North Dakota. 1st and 10. Harnish pursued by Legit. Oh, beautiful throw on the run and a diving grab by Landon Cox. Got a first down across the 33-yard line.
As you see Chandler rolling out to his right, looking for his key go-to guy. Cox finds him, gets down, first down. Keep the drive going. They've got to score quickly on this drive. It's a two-possession game right now.
Landon Cox led the team with 45 receptions, 4 touchdowns a year ago. 1st and 10. That's Palmer, the speed receiver in motion. This is a quarterback keeper. Oh, Harnish got a couple of good blocks. Harnish into the clear. Bellamy's got a pursuit angle on him and slows him up, and down he goes near the 20-yard line. Justin Green finally caught him. Green is a sprint champion out of Kentucky, 2-time state 100-meter champion. Bellamy slowed him up, but look at this run.
Good patience in the hole. Good vision and good explosion, but you're not going to outrun Justin Green, the 2-time 100-meter champion there.
But he got 47 yards at a first down of the Illini 19-yard line. Not over yet, big fella.
Not over, not quite yet. You know, this team is going to go out kicking and screaming. They're not going to go easy.
Harnish, longest run of his career, is a redshirt junior. Hopkins looking to throw. Got a man open in the end zone. Touchdown, Landon Cox.
Pass complete from Jasmine.
Little razzle dazzle to get back into the game.
I'll tell you what. You get a guy that runs east and west, draws up the defense, and they just completely forgot about Landon Cox. Now, as he dropped, now can we pause the film right there? That's just a great play right there. I mean, he draws the defense to him. And as they come closer and he's looking like he's going to run the ball, he lets it go for the touchdown to Cox.
Klimovsky, the former Illini, with the extra point. Little celebration on the sideline. Hopkins, the running back, finds the wide receiver, Landon Cox, and Husky's back in it.
Doc, I just got your email. I'm out for the season.
Don't worry about that. I switched to Sprint's $69.99 plan, so I get unlimited emails.
What does that mean?
It means I'm dropping you for my fantasy team, that's for sure.
What does that mean about my knee?
Oh, your knee's totally shattered. You see how hard that guy hit you?
I don't want to see...
Hey, relax. Not costing me any extra.
Only Sprint gives you unlimited text, web, and calling to any mobile for just $69.99. Sprint, the Now Network.
As you rebuild your financial future, there may be times you could use a hand. But with 130 years of experience, the Principal has the retirement, investment, and insurance solutions to help lighten your load. We even created a website full of ideas to help you and your financial advisor plan a better way forward. Visit AmericaRebuilds.com or ask your advisor about rebuilding with the Principal.
At Polaris, we designed a trail-dominating legend, the Sportsman XP, to lead a new team of smooth-riding trail runners. We made a versatile, powerful, mid-size Ranger, launching a new group of value-minded workhorses. And we made the ultimate hunting vehicle, the Ranger XP, even better, heading up a new team of hard-working hunting machines. From the number one maker of ATVs and side-by-sides, Polaris. Hardest working, smoothest riding.
Today, Ben Chappell leads the explosive Indiana offense into a showdown with Western Kentucky.
Touchdown!
Today in HD, only on the Big Ten Network.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Big Ten Conference and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the expressed written consent of the Big Ten Conference.
And welcome back, and we're going to circle this guy right here, and I'm going to show you what he's going to do on this play. He does a great job of getting the ball, and I'll pause it right there. What he does when he gets that ball is he runs east and west, and before the previous series when he goes east and west, the defense just swarmed him. Well, they take advantage of it now. When he runs east and west, he gives that ball fake. He throws the ball up the field to Landon Cox, takes advantage of the defense.
Klubovsky's kickoff, short but high. Malines out across the 35-yard line. Good start for Illinois. Well, we mentioned the Huskies came in here not in awe of playing a Big Ten team. Matter of fact, they knocked off the Purdue Boilermakers almost a year ago to the day at Purdue last year. That was the opener at Wisconsin, and they were in that game all the way against the Badgers. And then the year before at Minnesota, a close ball game. So this program, this MAC program up in DeKalb, Northern Illinois Huskies, they can play with the big boys on occasion, no doubt about that. And they relish the opportunity to play here. First game between these two schools in 9 years on the football field. Not a whole lot there. Second down upcoming. Mikel Ashore is trying to run some clock here. That drive by Northern Illinois, 80 yards in three plays, took only 67 seconds off the fourth quarter clock, and we got a ball game once again.
Now they've got the ability to go to the distance, and if this defense can hold here, they'll give that offense another opportunity to go the distance and make this a close game.
Shieldhouse, ball was tipped. Ball tipped at the line, fell harmlessly incomplete. It's third down and seven for the Illinois offense. Mike Krause apparently got a piece of it. Boy, he's had a nice second half. Called his number several times.
Paul Petrino has got this guy, Nathan Shieldhouse, on top of his game today. And now with a third and long, they need to convert and keep this drive going there and take NIU out of this ball game here.
Illinois only 4, 12, and third downs. Third and seven. Shieldhouse in the flat. Diving for the first down. Did he get it? They're marking him short. Mikel Ashore sprawled out, tried to reach for it, and came up a yard short.
Mikel Ashore reaching to the sideline, but he steps out prior to reaching that first down marker. And that referee crew is right on top of these calls. They're doing a pretty good job of getting the right marks.
How about this right here? It looks like Illinois is going to gamble on fourth and one at the Illini 46-yard line in a two-point ball game. 4:54 to go. The straight eye formation, LeShore. How much of a gamble really was it?
Raquel the score, Rutgers point, Illinois. First down.
We welcome the audience joining us from the Ball State-Purdue game. Purdue winning 28-13. Illinois has just picked up a huge first down on fourth and one from their 46-yard line. Mikel LaShore gets the call and picks it up.
The clock is clearly the enemy for NIU right now. They need to get this Illinois powerhouse offense off of the field.
So Purdue score is 24-13, not 28-13. Hand off to Pollard. Well, fake to Pollard. Shieldhouse on the key. Got a first down, down to the 40-yard line of Northern Illinois. Well, that was just huge, and you wonder, you know, I mentioned gambling, I guess, but when you have Mikel LaShore back there and you've got the big fullback, Jay Pross, in front of him, how much of a gamble really is it?
Yeah, you're playing your odds right there, and, you know, with that big offensive line, you got a big power back. You know, that's an attitude play, and put the emphasis on the shoulders of your offense to win this game, and I think Paul Petrino is trying to do that here.
First and 10. Once again, getting the call, Pollard, who's seeing some time here in this fourth quarter. He's more of a changeup back and kind of a receiver out of the backfield.
Troy Pollard comes in, and they just run the same play that has been successful in the first half and actually throughout the whole course of this ball game. The other person running it was Mikel LaShore, and Nathan Shieldhouse has the option to either hand that ball off to the running back or keep it himself, and he's been making some really, really good decisions here.
Shieldhouse has rushed 16 times for 115 yards. He's got LaShore behind him in a single back look. Oh, LaShore stacked up. They were ready for that as he tried to take it off the right side. Sean Progar on the interior of that line for Northern Illinois. All over that play, along with Stephen O'Neill, the defensive end.
Jerry Kill has got to be careful. He's running on the field. He's upset. But what something is going on the field that's upsetting him. And he lost his headset there. But he's an emotional guy. You can tell that his team is playing with that same high level of emotion. Here comes a third and long. It's important for them to get off the field so they have an opportunity to score and win this ball game.
Big play for the Northern Illinois defense. Trailing by two, third and almost 11. Just outside the Husky 41-yard line. Shieldhouse with Jason Ford alongside him. Wide open, Jenkins gets the first down. Underneath the coverage of Kyrie Daniels, first and 10 for the Fighting Illini at the Northern Illinois 30-yard line.
Is Jenkins a possession receiver? He's averaging about 10 yards a catch today, and that one there goes for another 10 yards. Important.
They didn't give him the 30-yard line. I thought for sure he reached it across at the 30. But watch this on the spot of the ball. No, he did not. He had to get just inside the 31 of Northern Illinois, and it looks like they've got it spotted just short. Play right in front of Ron Zook, so he'll get a good look at it.
And if this ball comes up short, does Dembke have the leg to kick this?
No need to kick. They got first down by the nose of the football, it appears. There's another look at it. Didn't get it by much.
Not by much, but all you need to do is cross that marker, and you're in business.
Now with 2:10 to go, Jerry Kill still has two timeouts left on the Husky sidelines. First and 10, Illinois. Shieldhouse with Ford alongside. Ford hit by Progar. Ford driving forward just inside the 30. Timeout taken by Northern Illinois, stopping the clock with a minute 51 to go in the game.
John Progar on the stop for Northern Illinois.
Stay tuned for the State Farm wrap-up for scores, highlights, and analysis of today's games. We know we've got an audience that joined us from the Purdue Ball State game, won by Purdue this afternoon. In this game here, Illinois took a 6-0 lead early. The Huskies scored the next 12 points. Illinois led at halftime And then it was back and forth. Illinois extended the advantage in the second half, and then NIU with a late touchdown drive and right back into it to make it a two-point game, and Illinois trying to salt it away here. They had to pick up a first down on a fourth down call at their own 46-yard line, which seemed like a gamble, but again, when you consider you got Mikel Ashore in there, he's averaging 6.8 yards a carry in his career almost, and, you know, they picked it up.
Illinois has dominated this game, the kicking game, offensively, defensively in this game. They've given up a couple good big plays on defense, but other than that, they've controlled the line of scrimmage and they've stymied the rushing game for NIU and Chad Spann.
Ashore the lone back. Illinois rushed for 291 yards on 47 running attempts here this afternoon. Ashore with a seal around the end of the 20. To the house. Touchdown.
Anytime you have a big run, you're going to see great blocking downfield. Milanes gets his block, stays with his man. Mikel Ashore does the rest, finds the end zone. Touchdown, Illinois.
You wide receivers are responsible for more big runs than given credit for. You're right. That wide receiver held his block forever. He kept blocking. The extra point is good by Derek Dimke. Illinois now leads 28-19 with a minute 43 to go.
As Mikel Ashore rounds that corner, it's always good to see your wide receivers down the field blocking for you. And look at Milanes right there. Knocks his guy down to the turf and allows Mikel Ashore to do the rest of the work.
He kept Rashawn Melvin out of the way, and Melvin's made a lot of tackles on the perimeter of the defense for Northern Illinois.
Jared Faison also threw a block in there. As he turned that corner, you saw Jared Faison, two of the wide receivers, throwing blocks down the field, allowing him to go untouched into the end zone.
Ashore, 24 carries, 180 yards.
A good seal on the edge there by the tight end, Evan Wilson, blocking down the field. Faison, Milanes, touchdown.
29-yard touchdown run. Another big day for Mikel Ashore. Northern Illinois has one timeout remaining and a minute 43 with which to work. But this was a ball game very, very late.
That was one of those plays where, you know what, my truck is bigger than your truck, and I'm going to run you over.
In the end, the big truck's going to win.
Exactly.
Twin safeties back deep for the Huskies. Let's see if Dimke gives him a chance. Yep, he's going to kick it away. But deep into the end zone. So Derek Dimke, who's hit a couple of field goals today and has been perfect on his extra points. Mikel Ashore, a career high 24 carries, 180 yards.
And you talk about the four-minute offense at the end of games. You got to run the clock down. You got to score points. Keep the other team's offense off of the field when you have that lead. And right there, Paul Petrino's offense just flat out gets it done. And not only do they drive down the field, but they score a touchdown on that last drive.
Next up for Illinois will be the Ohio State Buckeyes here in Champaign on October 2nd. First and 10 for the Huskies. Arnish with that shoulder fake. Hits the tight end marks once again. Breaks a couple of tackles. How about this one? All the way out to the 36-yard line. That looked like Mike Ditka in Pittsburgh in 1963 in black and white.
No quitting this guy. I tell you what, he finds a cavity once again in that defense. And boy, rumbling, stumbling, bumbling. You know, he is not going to go down. Refuse to lose.
First and 10. Harnish on the keep, out to the 40-yard line. We're inside, 90 seconds to go. Martez Wilson makes the stop. Illinois, I mentioned their upcoming schedule. I mentioned Ohio State would be coming here. Here's what the upcoming schedule through October looks like. Road games, Penn State and Michigan State. Following that, Ohio State date here. Harnish on second down. Incomplete. Going high into the air was Landon Cox. Could not bring that one down.
He does make a valiant effort right there to catch a high ball. He can't quite bring it in, but at least it stops the clock. It allows him to dial up another play.
54 seconds left to go here in Champaign. Been a tough one for the Fighting Illini of Illinois. They trailed most of the first half, had the lead at halftime, extended it in the fourth quarter, and then had Northern roar right back into it, cut the deficit down to two, and then the late touchdown by LeShore, 24-yard ramble. Again, marks the tight end out to the 50-yard line, but the Illini are going to give them the center of the field. They want to keep everything away from the sidelines and force Northern Illinois to use its last time out. First down for the Huskies. Three-man down line defensively for Illinois. Clay Nurse coming free. Pass tipped by Wilson. Intercepted by Ian Thomas. Penalty marker down to the offensive backfield. I wonder if it's for a high tackle attempt on the quarterback by Clay Nurse, the defensive end. Marker was thrown right at the quarterback.
Personal foul.
Passer. Number 97. Defense. 15-yard previous spot. Automatic. First down.
Going on there, Wayne, huh? You got that right on the money. And although it didn't really come back to bite him, I know this has to be an area of emphasis for this ball club. And, you know, Ron Zook has to be concerned about the amount of penalties. I think it's 7 or 8 penalties in this ball game.
First down now for Northern. Down 28-19. Varnish. Perez Ashford has been somewhat quiet, makes his first catch of the day just inside the 31, a gain of almost 5 yards, and the final timeout taken by Jerry Kill and the Huskies of Northern Illinois.
That's their third and final charge timeout.
It's a heads-up play. It's a heads-up play there by the defense, and knowing that you need to keep the ball carrier in bounds. Allow Perez to catch that ball, Ashford catches the ball, and then they close on him and get him in bounds. You see Ron Zook there. He's not happy about the penalties. And maybe a couple other little things that are going on, but he'll do a good job of getting those guys straight, making sure that they play with some of this precision and attention to detail that he emphasizes. Changing the culture is what he's trying to do over here with this Illinois club.
There's the player, the Phillips player of the game, Mikel LeShore. 24 carries, 180 yards, and a touchdown here this afternoon. Well, I tell you, his number is just outstanding, and take a look at him.
Razzling, dazzling, running guys over, through, around, you name it. He got it done today. Breaking tackles, breaking loose, vision, the total package. Paul Petrino called this guy the total package. And I think that's maybe maybe a statement, a short of what he actually is. I mean, he has really had an exceptional ball game today.
Northern Illinois is down 9. They're going to try this field goal. And Klimovsky, the former Illini, kicking it. This is a 48-yard field goal attempt. And the kick is up, and it is good. Now, this cuts the deficit to 6.
Hands team, get ready.
19 seconds remaining, and you know the onside kick coming up.
Hands team, you know, here's the part of the game that I never like, right? Because you're going to get teed off on, you know, as you try to recover the ball, you're going to take a ton of shots. And, man, this is a part of the game that I always dreaded as a wide receiver, because I knew that I was going to have to go up and sacrifice my body on one of these kinds of plays.
We want you guys with good hands on this one here, you know? Secure the ball.
Secure the ball,
yeah,
right.
You know, and of course, I would imagine, Moose, in your career at Michigan State and even in the NFL, you probably didn't play on special teams much beyond that, you know,
beyond college, yeah. Well, you know, my first 3 years, they made me pay my dues, Wayne.
Well, at Michigan State, you were the gunner, right?
Yeah, in the NFL, too, I played the first 3 years on special teams, and then after that... Not much after that.
You were a pretty wide receiver, see? Yeah. Special teams, not your deal.
No, not after that.
Interesting, though, because you're right. On all levels of football, guys have to sometimes make their mark on special teams before they get a chance on offense or defense. All right, Klimovsky, anticipated onside kick. 19 seconds to go. Desperate times require desperate measures. That's the case for the Huskies. Klimovsky, and it is caught. Caught by Jared Faison, and that should do it. At the 43-yard line of Northern Illinois, the Huskies out of timeouts. 18 seconds to go of the game.
Resilience. Ron Zook's resilience with this football team. Today, they just showed that they were the better football team. Faison recovering it to seal the deal. But I'll tell you what, I mean, they just, you know, trying to establish a new identity for this organization. It's been a challenge for Ron Zook, but, you know, he's up for that challenge. And he brought in new defensive coordinator Coney, and he brought in a new offensive coordinator Petrino. And these guys showed up today with the best game plan that they could come up with, and it worked.
And they knew they would be tested by Northern Illinois, and indeed they were throughout the afternoon here today, right down to the end. And Illinois comes away with a 28-22 victory over the Huskies of Northern Illinois. Illinois with the win now, 2-1. And they'll head to Big Ten play on October 2nd. Good tune-up for the Big Ten season because, and as I think you brought up a great point, Ron Zook not real happy with some of what was going on late in the ball game. He's not going to be happy at all with the number of penalties called on his team, that's for sure. He knows they have to clean up that aspect of it as they go forward in the Big Ten play. But what they've got is a running attack, and they've had that for the last 5-6 years that they can rely on, and that's something that'll hold them in good stead, I think, in the Big Ten. And that man right there, Mikel LeShore, Doak Walker Award candidate, over 100 yards rushing in each of the first three games of the season. Coach Ron Zook of the Fighting Illini of Illinois joins us. Coach Zook, congratulations on the victory. You knew it would be tough, and it certainly was.
Well, and really, there's no question. And, you know, as you look at this game, it was probably really good for us. We knew we were going to get stretched. And we knew it was going to be that kind of thing, and it's a good football team. We knew they were going to play their hearts out. We were a little flat today, but, you know, once again, I think a good football team, and we're starting to become one. You got to win those kind of games, and I'm not so sure we'd have won that game last year.
Well, in the closing moments there, you sealed the victory, Coach. First half might have been a little bit shaky. It was an even ball game there. But what about the penalties, Coach? Is that something that you want to try to clean up? Because, you know, it might go different with these kind of penalties in the Big Ten.
Well, I don't think there's any question. You know, that's something we have to look at and, make sure that there are penalties. And, we got to play smart. I think any time I worried about that when we went, it was so easy the first two series, offensively and defensively. You know, if you relax a little bit and you try, and hopefully we have to learn from that. I don't know that it'll ever happen again, but you can't relax. We did a little bit, and to their credit, they did a good job. But our guys came back when they had to.
Coach Zook, thank you very much. Congratulations. You got a bye week next week, and then Ohio State coming up. Good luck in the upcoming conference season.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
That's Ron Zook, the head coach of the Fighting Illini of Illinois. Crowd of almost 51,000 on hand here at Memorial Stadium. Let's go right back down to the field. Mikel LeShore, the star of the game, joins us. Mikel, talk about your performance today. What a tremendous game you had today with 180 yards and 24 carries.
Yeah, it was a tough game. It was a four-quarter game. It was real close the whole way. And we just had to come out and execute in the fourth quarter. That's what it came down to, and I think we did a good job at that.
All right, thanks a lot. Just let me ask you this. What does that fist mean to you?
Oh, man, Coach emphasized that since spring ball. And we came together, especially in that fourth quarter, and we were strong out there, and we willed to win. That was our whole thing this whole week. We had the will to win.
Well, thanks for coming on with us, Mikel. Awesome game today. Keep up the good job.
Thank you, man. I appreciate it.
Mikel LeShore, the star of the game for Illinois, as the Fighting Illini win it 28-22 here at Memorial Stadium. Moose, good ball game as we expected.
Yeah, you know, and it was action-packed, all the way down to the very end. He had some great plays, outstanding plays. Nathan Shieldhouse dazzling the crowd, over the top, around the corner, Harnish. I mean, it's everything that you could ever want out of a matchup with the Big Ten team.
For Mohsin Mohammed, I'm Wayne Larrabee. Our entire Big Ten Network crew in Champaign. That's it for Memorial Stadium. Final score, 28-22, Illinois. Let's go to the Chicago studio and Dave Revson.
It is the State Farm Big Ten football wrap-up. Dave Revs and Jerry.
Final score, Virginia 34, Georgia 27.